play a good game, competitive, bring their best, lots of energy. We will drop the puck when we come back.
Financial barriers to sport and play. 100% of donations support kids in local communities.
Whether you're at Raj's or Han's or Maria's, there's a Molson with your name on it. Canadian, XL, Ultra, Molson. Everyone in.
Harvey's knows Canadians like things in threes, like hat tricks, football downs, the prairies, and now pickles. Thanks to our triple pickle poutine with deep fried and diced pickles and our creamy garlic dill sauce. It's a taste trifecta. Harvey's.
This week at The Brick, when you buy more, you save more. Discover huge discounts on appliances. Plus, get up to an extra $500 off select major kitchen appliances. Up to 40% off mattresses. Up to 30% off furniture. And take 3 years to pay with no interest. Plus, when you buy more, we give more. A portion of proceeds from our sales will be donated to your local children's hospital. Thank you, Canada, for helping us raise over $17 million. The Brick, saving you more.
Goaltenders for tonight's preseason finale. It is Sam Montembeau getting the call for Montreal, his third appearance of this preseason. The last time we saw him in action was Saturday against Toronto. And it's Linus Ullmark for Ottawa. He had the night off yesterday, back between the pipes. He played the entire game Tuesday against Montreal, stopping 29 of the 32 shots he faced. All right, we are set to drop this puck from our nation's capital. So without further ado, let's get you back to Brian and Jamie at the Canadian Tire Centre.
Laura, it was a beautiful sunny day in the nation's capital, but tonight it is hockey. It is the final preseason game for both the Ottawa Senators and Montreal Canadiens. And there is a great sight for Habs fans. Jamie, Caden Gooley back in the lineup. His first preseason action tonight.
Yes, the 22-year-old rear guard gets his first opportunity and shake the cobwebs off, get a little bit of habits in his game, and he can settle in right before the regular season starts. So it's always nice to get one underneath your belt. Why not do it against a rival, the Ottawa Senators?
Gooley signing a six-year extension, $33 million last season, had six goals, 22 points, career highs for him. And Jamie, it is a rematch of Tuesday at the Bell Center. Things got a little bit chippy. A lot of people wondering who would be in the lineup tonight. Well, a lot of the bigs aren't in the lineup. Montreal Canadiens top line not playing. Arbor Jacki is in. Tkachuk, Stützle out. Ridley Gregg, he was the center of attention as well as that game. He's not playing, but it's a chance for Marty St. Louis and Travis Green to get one more look tonight.
It's all about evaluation. Guys that are on the bubble, this is your last opportunity to make that impression on the head coaches and management. And for veteran guys who are playing, it's that last opportunity to settle into your game before the real dance starts.
And Gooley settles in right away. Why not a quick hit 5 seconds in as he starts physical, and the hit right there on Cole Reinhart.
The easiest way for a player to get involved is get physical. So like you mentioned, 5 seconds in, step up, a little physicality through Cole Reinhart. And hey, welcome to the league. And hey, I'm settling right back in, making an instant impact. That's what Gooley's capable of.
Well, the refs saw a lot of that Tuesday at the Bell Center. 79 minutes in penalties for both teams. It got a little out of hand. Underway here on this Saturday night. And there is Gooley. He'll swing it up the left side. It ricochets all the way to Sanderson. Little backhand towards Ullmark.
Getting him involved early on. Nothing wrong with that.
Ullmark and Montembeau, your starters tonight. Here is Gooley. Across Engstrom wanted Josh Anderson, who's in the lineup tonight. On a line with Gallagher and Evans to start things off. Engstrom. It will take it away momentarily. He lost the puck. It's chipped in. As in comes Shane Pinto for Ottawa. Turnover. Wrist shot right on Montembeau. Rebound. Score. Quick strike. Pinto buries it. 1-0 Ottawa.
This all starts with a great forecheck. Shane Pinto does a great job. Now he's going to finish it off. But it's a chip and chase play into the blocker side of Montembeau. Here it is. Speed through the neutral zone. Really looking for options up the wall. Turn it over. But there's the stick right on top of the puck. Turned over. Head up the whole way. The initial save. But it's Pinto who makes his way to the front of the net off the initial offering. And he wraps it past the left leg of Montembeau. And it's an early quick strike offense for the Ottawa Senators on home ice.
And Jamie, there's a guy that would love a big season. Signed a 2-year extension, 7.5 mil. Obviously, half the season last year. Played for the United States at the IIHF World Hockey Championship in Czechia. Was really strong for the United States. John Hines relied on him, moved him around the lineup, ended up on the top line for some time there as well, and gets Ottawa off to a good start here tonight.
Well, Pinto's, I think he's a big part of this team, especially you want strength down the middle of the ice. Well, Pinto's a big part of that, and you mentioned missing half the season last year. That forced Ridley Gregg on some nights into some tough matchups, and now with Ridley Gregg a year underneath his belt.
And you saw Arbor Jacki, the cross-check on Gaudette, and right away, McEwen steps up, and you knew something like this could happen. Arbor Jacki, right, McEwen answering the call. He gets a right going. Arbor, the takedown, as Arbor Jacki, public enemy number one in Ottawa.
Well, you knew it right away, and McEwen is going to stand up for his teammates. Jacki, no stranger to altercations. And that's a good tilt. We're seeing a lot of emotion, a spirited start here, a goal and a fight 90 seconds in. Here's how it unfolds there in the neutral zone. The physicality right there. Jacki and McEwen right away drops the gloves. They end up squaring off before they start throwing punches. Jacki and McEwen, two big customers going after it. And you and I were talking about it, Brian, off air. I thought this might have been a bit of a snoozer, a little bit of like, hey, let's have a 2-hour skate out here. Nothing to see. But
nobody get hurt. No injuries.
Exactly, with the regular season around the corner. That's not the case. We've got goals, we've got fights, and seems like the rivalry continues, even though it's still preseason.
Marty St. Louis said earlier today on Arbor Jacki, I want him to play a full game. Play hard. He's a player that will toe the line. He wants him to be smart, get some honest reps, and move on. So that's the mission for the head coach for Arbor Jacki tonight, and he answers the bell, what, not even 2 minutes into this one.
Well, that one was, listen, I wouldn't say it was forced, but it's a hit through the neutral zone. McEwen went right at him. McEwen was the aggressor on that play, so Jacki is not going to back down from that fight.
And Montreal does get the power play instigator as Engstrom shoots. Gallagher in front, reaching for it. Ullmark stopped it, still loose as Joshua Waugh digs it free. Montreal would love to get a power play goal in the preseason. They come in 0-for-25. And, of course, a lot of the usual suspects not on the power play. It's the preseason, so you're working on things. But it'd feel good to plop one here for Martin St. Louis.
Montreal's power play has been so anemic the last couple of years. That's why the loss of Patrick Laine is so devastating, because he would have been a guy who could certainly be a difference maker with the man advantage, that one-timer spot. Not that Cole Caulfield isn't very dangerous from that area, but it's more about, you know, finding a spot for Patrick Laine. They're going to have to wait a couple months until he's healthy to do that.
Montreal, a chance to set things up. Joshua Waugh will deliver in deep for the Habs. Chabot reaching for it. There's new hook for Dvorak. Dvorak up top. Engstrom. Dvorak drops it off. Back up. Engstrom across. Kapanen. Engstrom. Waugh. Puck on his stick. Try to slide it in front. Dvorak got dumped. Joshua Waugh again below the goal line. Waugh goes up top. Engstrom. Kapanen. Engstrom. One-time drive. Oh, Dvorak in front. What a right pad save from Ullmark there. Engstrom one more time. Some good looks for Montreal here as they work it around again. In front, Newhook with a chance. Just over his stick. Didn't get the shot he wanted. And Josh Norris able to clear for Ottawa.
You mentioned the Ullmark save. Now, Ullmark is really good. He's a big goaltender. He's got great extremities. Seals the ice very well. He's able to get a right pad on the Waugh chance in tight.
He got the win Tuesday at the Bell Center, starting in the preseason finale. Of course, Ottawa played last night in Detroit, won in overtime. Imore, some good moves. One on two, right through backhand. pass and a left pad stop. Montembeau. Hamonic works it across. And that drive by Gignac. Hamonic takes the body check as Condotta hit him. So both goalies, some good reflexes in those pads kicking out. Near turnover there in front, but Gignac able to recover as Gaudette has had a wonderful preseason for Ottawa. Four goals and counting for our Gaudette.
Well, that chance for a stop shot was all made possible by Highmore up the forecheck.
Jake Evans cutting in, tries to go short side, couldn't cash in. Goes up top, William Trudeau. He'll work it across. And a whistle, high stick coming up. And it'll be Pezzetta, it looks like, going to the box. So Michael Pezzetta, the high stick in front of Allmark.
Right off the forecheck in front of the net. Pezzetta gets a stick up.
Montreal number 55. 2 minute minor penalty, high sticking.
He's going to sit for two or less, and that's what it... He's just battling for position in front of the net as the puck ended up going wide, getting thrown towards the net. And Pezzetta is a guy who's no stranger to try and establish position. And here's what happens. Right in front of the net, battling right there with Tyler Cleven. Gets the stick up right across the side of the face. Contact, and it's called. And Ottawa gets their first opportunity on the power play.
Justin Barron on the puck. He'll pound that down the ice right to Allmark. Jake Sanderson will collect for the Ottawa Senators. Nearly 5 minutes gone here in this first period. Greg Batherson to the right side. Pinto falls as he was hit by Emil Heinemann. Comes near point. Jake Sanderson hit the skate of Evans. Batherson, though, throws it across. Norris, Sanderson. Josh Norris, second preseason game for him. He'll go down low. Pinto to Norris. Sanderson to Batherson. And a good stick, Evans, got in the lane. Pinto takes some contact. Caden Gooley finds the puck, and a good clear from Gooley, and he'll work that down the ice.
A great read by Jake Evans at the top of the umbrella. As you can see, they were trying to force feed that pass through the seam to Josh Norris. Evans able to read that, turn that puck over, and then get it down 200 feet.
Ottawa had four power play goals back on Tuesday versus Montreal, and another one coming.
Be a tripping penalty. Josh Anderson, I think. Nope, sorry.
Looks like Dvorak.
Yeah, Dvorak is...
Montreal number 28, 2 minute minor for tripping.
Leading his case. So Ottawa's gonna in a 5-on-3 situation for 59 seconds. Marty St. Louis is gonna get a look at his penalty kill. Here's the trip along the wall. Stick on top of the laces of Nick Cousins. Now Cousins is no stranger to agitating and drawing penalties and does a good job right there. So now the power play for the Senators. Again, an extended 5-on-3 look here.
Cousins, one assist in 12 games in that playoff run for the Panthers as he won a Stanley Cup, and now one of the veteran pieces. Jimmy, we talked about it off the top that Steve Saios, Dave Poulin brought in to kind of solidify this team and these young players.
Well, you mentioned Amadio, guys like Cousins who have been to the dance and won. You know, that bleeds through the dressing room from a leadership standpoint.
Talked about Jensen Perron as well. Yep. Shabbat has the puck behind the net. And the goalie Ulmer is a leader and a great goalie as well for Ottawa. So 5-on-3 for the Senators. A chance to go up 2-0 here. Shabbat. Great spots with Sanderson. Down low, Norris. There's a guy that would love to get one. Josh Norris. Wrist shot tip in front and a good stop. Montembeau again. As Pinto, a good screen and tip. Sanderson. Reshot tip, score in front. Pinto, another one. Power play goal, 2-0 Ottawa.
This is a set play. It's a beautiful tip by Shane Pinto in front. Jake Sanderson fires that, but it's more about the placement of the shot. It's about 3 feet off the ice. Shane Pinto is in front. Montembeau, that's his responsibility. But watch Pinto. He's actually waving his stick at Jake Sanderson, saying, give it to me right here. Look at waving, waving, waving down the middle of the ice. Little redirect. That goes 5-hole on Montembeau. 1-0 for the, I'm sorry, 2-0 for the Ottawa Senators. A beautiful play by Pinto to redirect as he doubles down here early on in the game.
Two goals in about 6 minutes of work for Shane Pinto, and they scored in time as there's still power play time, a minute five for Ottawa to work with. Burst of speed by Cousins, the one-time Montreal Canadian. Cross for Amadio. Amadio in front. Good block there as William Trudeau got down, took the lane away. There's Gregor, the OT hero from last night in Detroit, back in the lineup tonight. Noah Gregor. That wrist shot, that hit Gregor, never found its way through. Good job, Shabbat holds it in. Cousins. Nick Cousins setting up near circle for the Senators. Shabbat. They're working across. Pass down, Noah Amadio. And Montreal, good job to find it and clear. Down to Allmark, 23 seconds left of the man advantage.
A little bit more desperation on that penalty kill by the Canadians. You can see them trying to bear down on pucks. Loose puck battle with Amadio in the back behind the net. And it gets cleared 200 feet.
Good shot by Jan Janik off a skate. Janik's been noticeable as well in the preseason for Ottawa.
Getting underneath the skin of a few Red Wings players last night. Huge hit again by Dooley.
And Dooley's going to answer the call here. Strom right in front of the Montreal bench. You saw Stopchuk racing in. He's right into things. And, well, Dooley, welcome to the preseason. He's getting right into it in his first period of action.
Well, he's a really good anticipation player. And, again, it's a step-up closing play by Dooley. And it's a massive hit that draws a crowd and some physicality. We'll see how the refs are going to sort this one out because it's certainly a response from a stop shot.
Well, Marty St. Louis and his Habs, they've had a busy preseason, a lot of penalties, a lot of physicality, and a great start for Pinto. He's doubled down, scoring two thus far.
Financial barriers to sport and play. 100% of donations support kids in local communities.
When I was just a little girl, I asked my mother, what will I be? Will I be pretty? Will I be?
He did it again.
Yeah, poor guy.
Wow.
No!
They're gonna burn the whole city down now.
Arthur Fleck is a monster.
When, as you say, you saw me stab Mr. Kleinman Huff in the neck. Did I seem crazy to you?
We're gonna build a mountain.
Now playing only in theaters.
Caden Gooley sits in the penalty box after drawing a response. Now this is a massive hit on Matthew Highmore in the neutral zone. You know, it incites the conversation into, do you have to fight after every hit? Now, you could argue that might have been a bit late, a bit excessive in the preseason, but Caden Gooley is working on his timing. And right away, it's Klevin in there. It's a stop chuck right away. But Gooley has been noticeable in the first 7.5 minutes here for the Canadians. He's a physical guy. He wants to get involved. And that was a large collision with Matthew Highmore in the neutral zone.
So out of that, Ostapchuk gets the only penalty. And now they have Jan Janik sitting down there as well. Montreal on the power play. Pinto Newhook will line up to take the draws. Montreal will try to get one here in the first period. Engstrom hands it off. Newhook. There's Oliver Kapanen down low. Gallagher. Kapanen. Brendan Gallagher at the goal line. He'll wait. Dishes. Kapanen. Gallagher. Pass hit him in the skates. Gallagher took contact, keep the play alive. Engstrom. Capitan. Gallagher, backhand feed, one to Joshua Waugh. Couldn't find him and sent down the ice. Good job, Jake Sanderson, who got down and blocked.
Unbelievable read by Jake Sanderson. The minute that you take away the ice, Gallagher, that was a set play. He was just going to turn and fire that through the blue paint. Sanderson takes that option away. It gets cleared.
Adam Engstrom will drop it off. Skated in by Kapanen. Joshua Waugh, round the boards for Gallagher. He'll leave to Newhook. Newhook, Engstrom. Wrist shot tipped off the bar. Waugh, the tip in the high slot and post behind Ullmark. Engstrom. Kapanen, pop pass across. That wrist shot, Ullmark saw it, and Joshua Waugh skating by it. Couldn't get the shot away. And there was a veteran, Nick Jensen, in front trying to help out Ullmark.
That's good work by Nick Jensen because it allows Ullmark to see that puck. So if you have a clear-sighted shot from there, Ullmark takes it cleanly, and then the battle for the rebound is in front.
Josh Anderson tried to hand it off for Logan Mayhew, sent down the ice as Monson Bowell laid it back for Barron. Justin Barron using his speed through center ice. Throws it back. Barre Boulay over the blue line. He'll dish to himself off the boards. Work it in deep. Josh Anderson. 15 seconds left in the power play for Montreal. Barre Boulay. Near circle for the Habs. Waits. Down low. Dvorak tucks it with a forehand. Can't beat Ullmark. Another strong save, and Mayhew's parked in front. Back up top, time winding down. Anderson kicks it to his stick, rips it just wider. Ullmark might have got a piece as we're back to 5-on-5 hockey. Barron at the line. Far circle. Again, Josh Anderson. Barre Boulay, a nice setup. Josh Anderson, that's the guy Montreal would like to get going hot early. Preseason, regular season. Anderson having one of his worst years ever last year in the NHL.
Yeah, shooting percentage was poor. He just couldn't get on the scoreboard. Now he's a big, strong guy. He's got a good shot. He certainly would like to get a good start. Now, the fact that they play the Toronto Maple Leafs to start, he is a guy who's quite a big factor against the Maple Leafs.
Pezzetta looking for it. Played in front. And a good job, Gignac. As that line created a little something out of nothing there off a turnover. And again, the veteran goalie, Linus Ullmark, will settle things down.
He's been really sharp early on. Now he gets a little bit of luck to redirect in the high slot with Waugh. You see he's in position, doesn't even track that. It's all about being in the right angles. The Habs still struggling on the power play here. The preseason struggles continue and 0 for 27. As I mentioned before, that Patrick Laine injury doesn't help that situation whatsoever.
I guess, though, Jamie, the good news, it is not as bad as a lot of people thought. It'll be, what, 2 to 3 months, no surgery and rehab. So that was really good news. And you just want Laine, the person and the hockey player, to feel comfortable and settle in Montreal.
100%. I agree.
Pezzetta coming in, took a bit of a shoulder. Drop pass in front. Heidemann shuttle. Ullmark out, and then he swats it away. Heidemann got tripped up in the corner. Good look from him, though. Arbor Jacki, he'll work it across. Down over Heidemann, spinning, trying to center. You know, Heidemann, one of those guys trying to battle for a spot with the injury to Patrick Laine. Pezzetta, Levin, little poke on him. There's Hamonic. Checked by Kapanen, who had a strong world championship as he got hot early, led the tournament with 5 goals early and representing his country. They were at O2 Arena in Prague, which is where the NHL regular season has officially started. Devils and Sabres opening up the regular season in Europe.
New Jersey 2-0.
Yeah. Yeah, Jonathan Kovechkin, the former Montreal Canadian, as he was called, had a goal and a helper in one of those games. I loved it. Sheldon Keefe, that was awesome.
Listen, New Jersey looks pretty good. Jacob Markstrom looks sharp for them, so they went and got their goalie in the offseason. You hope that maybe the Ottawa Senators, who went and got their goalie in the offseason, and he's looked really sharp early on. Linus Ullmark, I love, he's a big goaltender. He moves really well side to side. That's been on display tonight.
Artem Zub up at the near point. That wrist shot into the glove. You know, Jamie, to follow that up, Jaromír Jágr looks like he could still play. And then I remembered, well, he is still playing pro for his team in Czechia as he dropped the opening faceoff over in Prague.
Around here with our two jobs and a teenager in school, our internet situation was getting kind of hairy.
No, I don't want to split hairs, hon, but it was a mess.
We were practically pulling our hair out.
We were totally at loose ends.
Then we found a solution that's permanent.
Bell Pure Fiber.
Now there's not a hair out of place. Right, honey?
Plus, we trimmed our expenses.
And to think we nearly missed it by a hair.
I have a disability, but I'm not fragile. My first big hit was a rush. It made me feel alive in a way only sports can. Because of partners like Vail, I get to feel it on the world stage. And now I get to share that feeling with the next generation.
This week at The Brick, when you buy more, you save more. Discover huge discounts on appliances. Plus, get up to an extra $500 off select major kitchen appliances. Up to 40% off mattresses. Up to 30% off furniture. And take 3 years to pay with no interest. Plus, when you buy more, we give more. A portion of proceeds from our sales will be donated to your local children's hospital. Thank you, Canada, for helping us raise over $17 million. The Brick, saving you more.
Exciting news for the Ottawa Senators as well. Jamie, agreement in principle for that new arena downtown. 10 acres of land in the LeBreton Flats district. Hoping for a state-of-the-art facility in the Ottawa-Gatineau area. And that's just southwest of Parliament Hill in Ottawa. And that would be pretty exciting for this fan base.
It's so exciting on so many different levels to, you know, break ground to get a new arena. Listen, this arena has done a terrific job. The fan base has been awesome to make the trek out if you live downtown, but getting closer to downtown, you're going to build up a district. I don't think there's anything negative that's going to come out of that. The fan base can't wait, and I can't wait as well. It's going to be a state-of-the-art, beautiful arena, and the right people are involved.
There's Logan Mailloux, wrist shot, and that was blocked. Mailloux gets it back, and that was Jensen again. That stung as he blocked it. Brébeulé gets it down low for Heinemann. Brébeulé, maybe a player we should talk more about. Is Heinemann in, waiting, leaves it. Jack Guy shoots, glove, stop, over. What a save, and should we not be surprised? He has been so sharp in this preseason. Linus Ullmark.
Flashing the leather. It's a strong play out of the wall, off the wall. And a little option. You see, Jack Guy wants it, fires it past the screen. And it's just a terrific glove save by Linus Ullmark, who's in great position, rips it out of the air. A little Statue of Liberty. Danny Alfredson enjoying it. Alfie, the associate coach for Travis Green.
Hockey Hall of Famer behind the bench. Engstrom works it down low. Evans tried to slot that through. Evans was robbed on Tuesday at the Bell Center in tight. Ullmark kind of had that little smirk about him after the save. And he's been really sharp in this preseason. Engstrom for Evans. Jake Evans. Towards the net, into the glove. Anderson had his stick broken, so he had to go get a new one. A little pushing and shoving after the play.
You mentioned Linus Ullmark. Take a look at the numbers that he's put together with the Boston Bruins last two seasons. Win percentage, goals against, save percentage. Of course, the Vezina. It gets traded here to Ottawa. Boston's got their own issues now with Jeremy Swayman trying to get sorted out, but Ullmark has settled in. I think he's an unbelievable add. And let's not forget, Anton Forsberg and him have great chemistry. They're friends. They'll work hard. They'll push each other for the net. But I think this is a real positive situation here for the Senators heading into the season. I'd still believe, Muddy, that it's so important for this Ottawa Senators organization to start, actually for both these organizations, the start to the season with how competitive the Atlantic Division is. You've got to stay pace with the four teams that have been at the top in the last couple of years.
Well, Ullmark answering the call so far, a .942 save percentage, Jamie, in the preseason. And you talked about it, Ottawa seven straight years now missing the playoffs. They want to get back. And had a chance to chat with our good friend Dave Poulin, who's now in the management position with Ottawa. Yeah. And I said, you know, your two biggest priorities coming in. He said, number one, the goalie. We did that. Number two was solidifying these young players and our young captain with veterans. And you know what? Allmark does both. He's a leader and he's an outstanding goalie.
Well, he does. And you know, he brings that pedigree. He's won, you know, the Vezina. He's been recognized as one of the best goaltenders in the league. And we talked about the Stanley Cup pedigree they brought in as well.
Chance in front. William Trudeau pulls the trigger. Misses wide on the net. Got it. We'll send that in. Gaudette, we talked about his preseason. Really strong numbers. Had 44 in the American League last year. That led the AHL in goal scoring. Newhook using his speed. Allmark's forced to play it. There's Jensen. Amadio lost it. Newhook again. Centers. Law, fan on the shot. Pretty good look. And a setup from the speed of Newhook starting that play. Thomas Chabot. Good to see him healthy after having surgery on his hand in the offseason. Amadio centers. Good stick. Waugh broke that up. Chabot shovels it in. There's Justin Barron. Plays it to the far side. Yannick. He'll jam it in. Picked up by Trudeau. Under six to go in this first period. 2-0 Senators. Two goals from Shane Pinto. Christian Dvorak in stride up that left side. Try to get around Zub. And Dvorak will bring that in. A step offside. Shots 8-6 in favor of Montreal, but they're down 2-0 here in Ottawa.
At Hyundai, our SUVs are a testament to everything we stand for. And everything SUV stands for. Solid. Unique. Versatile. Sturdy. Unmatched. Valued. Safe. Uncompromising. Valiant. No wonder 94% are still on the road after 10 years. At Hyundai, we put the SUV in SUV, and we put the wow in wah.
My life is full of questions.
Mom, is yellow a light or a dark?
How do I clean an aioli stain?
Thankfully, Tide's the answer to almost all of them.
Why do we even buy napkins?
Clean cold water, clean white socks.
It came with Tide.
Do I need to pre-treat guacamole?
Not with Tide.
This is chocolate, right?
Just use.
Tide? Mm. Yeah.
No matter who's doing it, on what cycle, or in what temperature, Tide works. So I can focus on all the other questions.
Do crabs have eyebrows?
For all of life's laundry questions, it's got to be Tide.
Wayfair's big sale is finally here.
It's Way Day!
Right now, you can save up to 80% off at Wayfair.
Ooh, yes.
Plus, score free shipping on everything.
Ah! And surprise flash deals.
All way day long.
Shop Wayfair's big sale now through October 7th.
Wayfair, every style, every home.
Nick Cousins gets added in the offseason, and so Brian, we talked about what Dave Poulin had talked about as the checklist for the Ottawa Senators in the offseason, adding the goaltender and some veteran pedigree. They did both. Nick Cousins, Stanley Cup winner. Michael Amadio, Stanley Cup winner. Nick Jensen is a veteran rear guard, right-handed shot. David Perron has been successful everywhere. I feel like David Perron has gotten better with age. Like I almost felt there was a time maybe 8 years ago where he was struggling to find an everyday home. Three tours of duty in St. Louis, but I look at the additions for the Ottawa Senators, and then you have the incumbent. You've got Brady Tkachuk. You've got Tim Stützle. You've got Josh Norris. You've got Shane Pinto. You've got Drake Batherson. You have Thomas Chabot and now Jake Sanderson. That is your core, and then you've got veterans around him. Now, you're expecting these young players to get to the next level, too. That's the biggest challenge, is yes, you can add veteran guys, but the young players who've signed long-term deals have to find another level this season. I think it's imperative they continue with the word growth.
And I watched the broadcast last night, Jamie, that you were on in Detroit, and Ridley Gregg was a name you brought up, thinking that there's a player that could have a nice little season for Ottawa as well.
I think he's a special player that brings something unique to the table every night. You know, gets underneath your skin. Yes, he's not going to score 50 goals, but what he is going to do is be involved every night and bring something different to the lineup.
Drake Batherson going to work behind Montembeau. Montreal able to control to the left side. Turnover though, played right in front. Wrist shot, Montembeau stops Batherson. Giveaway by the Habs, and Montembeau bails him out again. And another storyline this year, it's Montembeau and Primo, the two young goalies, are going to have to carry the load for Montreal with Jake Allen now in New Jersey.
Well, yeah, the safety blanket of Jake Allen, the 34-year-old goaltender, is not there. So it is going to be their net. They're young guys. There is going to be nights that it might be a little bit leaner in front of them as far as support. It'll be taxing on that young duo, but they're going to have to find a way.
Montembeau, 49 career NHL wins. His three-year extension kicks in, $9.45 million. 16-15-9 last year. And that'll be the tandem, Montembeau and Primo. In comes Amadio, applies the body. Racing after that right side is Jake Evans. He'll chip and chase. Jensen gets back, and Allmark out to play. There's Pinto. Little backhand dish, wanted Amadio. Evans continues that fight for the puck. Drive from distance, tipped, and Gallagher just wide in front. Amadio, watched by Gignac. Gignac got his first goal in the National Hockey League last year with Montreal. It was a feel-good story for him. Time with New Jersey. And a long time after his draft year to finally get that goal. Drafted back in 2016, battled a lot, time in the American League, and able to cash one in last year. Here's Trudeau. Hit by Jensen. Condotta swinging at it, tried to wrap that in front. Allmark was ready. Joshua Waugh has had a wrist shot, and that hit a leg and went wide. Hit Condotta, and he's lost his skate blade. It's out to the right of Allmark, and that is an awful feeling as a player. As he runs into Pinto trying to get off the ice. Pass across, intended for Pezzetta, and Condotta trying to get some pace and get off and get that change in, and he will.
Pretty good balance by him, though, as he just one-legged right to the bench.
I mean, you played goalie, Jamie, but that has got to be awful. What an awful feeling to have that happen.
Nowadays, these blades that are interchangeable, the blades that are interchangeable, they come off so easily, but now you see them once in a while get knocked off on the ice and goes flying. Now all of a sudden he's in one, because that's a long way of real estate. That's a far way of real estate to get to the bench. And then how about earlier in the shift, Montembeau with a terrific right shoulder save on Drake Batherson in alone of a turnover.
So we're ready. I know the players are ready, Jamie. We're ready for the regular season. Ottawa will open up their season against the defending champs, Montreal versus Toronto at the Bell Center. But Ottawa's got a pretty tough schedule to start things off.
They do. They're facing, as you mentioned, the Stanley Cup champs. They play Vegas. They play Colorado. There's some teams that are really strong in the month of October for Ottawa. And as I mentioned before, it's so critical to start well if you're the Senators. So it'll be a test right from the drop of the puck early on.
On October 12th, these two teams will meet in the preseason, in the regular season at the Bell Center, wrapping up their preseason tonight. Mayhew got tangled up, a big hit with McEwen at center ice. Both no worse for wear, but here comes Cousins. He'll hand it off. Wrist shot, kick, save, Montembeau. Montembeau has been really good for Montreal in this first period. It could be 4 or 5-0.
I agree. He had the big save on Batherson in tight. That one with the left pad. Giving up a couple to Pinto, but you're right. This could be 4 or 5-0 here early on in this game. And this might be foreshadowing of some of the nights that he's going to face, where he's got to keep his team in it.
Jamie, as a goalie in a preseason, how many games did you want to get ready? How many?
I always felt like playing 3 or 4 games. And not full games, half games, where you just go through the game day routine.
There's Plevin, wrist shot, Knuckler. Hit a stick and went wide. Kamenik jams at it high off the glass. Batherson racing after it. There's Josh Norris as he leaves it. Gregor behind the net. Noah Gregor gets pinned by Emil Heinemann. Barré-Boulet able to dig it free for Montreal, and they skate away in numbers. Puck sent across. Barry Boulay wanted the pass from Dvorak. Dvorak couldn't get it there. Puck available side of the net as Montreal continues to work. Score! As it's jammed in front and they'll bury it. Dvorak has Montreal within one. I think Dvorak as they talk it over, but a good second effort there by the Habs.
This play all starts by a turnover by Drake Batherson inside the offensive zone blue line. Ends up on a 3-on-2. They never do get the puck back. Dvorak, I think it does go off of him. It's a bouncing puck off the net here. You're trying to have a loose puck battle. And if you're Batherson, you got to bear down on that puck. You got to win these loose puck battles. But good for Dvorak there, just going hard to the net. Gets a favorable bounce. And Montreal, we just talked about Montembeau keeping his team in it. Now all of a sudden, they respond with a goal. We've got a game here where if this game is 4-0, it's out of reach. But the goaltender gives them an opportunity to stay in it. And it's good work off the forecheck to turn the puck over. The Canadians have narrowed the gap to 2-1.
Second of the preseason for Dvorak, and he's a guy who's battled injury the last couple of seasons too. Had the knee, the torn pec muscle as well. He's a guy that can do a lot, you know what? It's a final year of his deal. He can win faceoffs, he can pilt penalties, and a real good depth centerman for Martin St. Louis and the Montreal Canadiens.
He's a versatile player, and to me, I was telling you before the game, I've always kind of wanted a little bit more from him. Let's take another peek at this goal. Is, you know, it's the turnover by Batherson. It's 3-on-2. Now it's a loose puck battle. Now you got to go to work down low. And for me, it's Barre Boulay does a good job of bouncing it off the net, getting it to the front of the net, and then it's Dvorak that does the rest to get it past Omar.
Ottawa trying to answer. Pinto looking for the hat trick already here in this first period. Final minute here at the Canadian Tire Center on this Saturday night. Artem Zub at the blue line trying to hold it down. There's Gallagher meets him. Amadio chasing after it, flip tie to center. 25 seconds left. Sanderson on the puck. Both teams getting a late change in. Arbor Jacki back as Montembeau will settle it down. Jacki for Gignac. Gignac up the right side, just missing the hit from Kleven, who tried to line him up. Pezzetta finishing his check. There's Cousins. Kleven, little flip, and that'll do it. So it was the Pinto show early, a goal, and then a power play marker, and then the late answer from Dvorak.
Pretty spirited first period. First 90 seconds had a goal and had a fight. And the type of tempo and I think intensity both coaches will enjoy after the first 20 minutes of a battle here, their last regular or the last exhibition game before the regular season.
Regular season starts next week in North America. It's a 2-1 game for Ottawa. The Canadian Tire Center here on this Saturday night. Intermission coming up next. Laura, Carlo, Claire, have you come?
They say dress for the job you want. Well, do we have some jobs for you? Now get purchase financing from 0% APR for up to 72 months.
Today, when it comes to following sports, a basic box score just won't cut it. Get the stats behind the stats with NHL Edge. So you won't just see Makar's time on ice. You'll see where he spent it. You won't just know Matthews scored. You'll know how hard he shot. And you won't just get OV's shot total. You'll know where he shot it from. Even if they're all from the same place. Know more about every stat, every shift, and every star with NHL Edge.
Fresh Stone Rollies, ready at any moment for real life moments. Loaded with your favorite flavors, Rollies keep you reaching for more. Share them, dip them, love them. Rollies, life rolled up.
There's regular cold. And then there's the mountains are blue cold. Mountain Cold Refreshment. Coors Light, the chill choice.
They say, dress for the job you want. Well, do we have some jobs for you? Now get purchase financing from 0% APR for up to 72 months.
On a distant world, you face the enemy.
vacuuming. Audible. There's more to imagine when you listen.
Buying a car is pretty daunting.
But the price badge on Auto Trader really gave me the confidence that I was putting my money to good use.
I think these features definitely boost the confidence.
The price badge is awesome.
The answer is Auto Trader.
Sweet mother of all that is good and pure.
Oh. Sit back with the sitcoms you can't get enough of on Crave.
Super asymmetry. That's it.
The exclusive streaming home of The Big Bang Theory.
Oh my God.
And Friends.
Oh, this is unbelievable.
Every season.
Yes, that's right.
Every.
How you doing?
And every.
Bazinga.
Are right here with so many more of your all-time favorites.
Well, I enjoyed that more than I thought I would.
On Crave.
Crave presents the next chapter in the Batman saga, starring Academy Award nominee Colin Farrell. Yes, that is him as the Penguin. An HBO original limited series is streaming now only on Crave.
Carly, going to check it out?
Yes, absolutely. I'm also going to check out the Montreal feature.
Shane Pinto getting it done there in the first period, scoring both goals for the Sens. Here he is now with Claire.
Shane, your head coach Travis Green said he wanted to see a strong start. Well, you get a goal 44 seconds in. How did that one feel?
Yeah, it feels good, obviously, to get on the board here. But it was a good start, but I thought we kind of tailed off there at the end. I think we got to do a better job of being more consistent. So, but definitely a good start, and hopefully we can bring that in the second.
Now, you were playing on Tuesday. There were definitely some scuffles on the ice between your teams. How would you rate the temperature so far in this game?
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty hot. Obviously, it started with Mac and Jack Eye, but... It's gonna be like that all night. I think we expected that, so just gotta be smart out there and keep your head up.
One thing you guys were fabulous at on Tuesday, penalty kills and also the power play. You score on the power play tonight. What's been working so far in this preseason?
Yeah, I think honestly we're just keeping it pretty simple. I think, Sandy there, he just kinda got it to the net and I got a stick on it. So I think we've been really emphasizing just getting pucks to the net and just crashing the net, so it's kinda been working so far.
Thank you, Shane.
Good. Thank you, Claire.
All right, and a much different start to the game than what we saw yesterday in Detroit as the Senators gave up the first goal not even a minute and a half into the game here on the board, 44 seconds in. And Shane Pinto, a player who definitely wants to put last season behind him, look ahead, and maybe this is something that he can carry over now into
the regular
season.
And if you're the Sens, you want to see Shane Pinto get hot in preseason because you're going to depend on him during this season to help lead your team. But look, it's the preseason, and the last thing you want to do in preseason is make the game longer than it needs to be. And here in Montreal, early in the first shift, just a brutal giveaway. Good job by Ottawa, and Pinto's the benefactor of that in front of the net. And so that's the 1-0 goal. You want your team to regroup, and instead, Montreal gets undisciplined. Again, don't make the game longer than it needs to be. It's the last preseason. Guys just want to get to the regular season. You take dumb penalties. You give Ottawa a two-man advantage. And Ottawa penalized Montreal last game by scoring on the power play a couple times. They get back to work here, and it's Pinto again with his second of the game so far. He gets off to a hot start. So the Ottawa Senators, they're up 2-0 at that point.
Yeah, that power play 4-for-9 on Tuesday in Montreal. The other big story, obviously, coming into this game was the rematch and all the rough stuff that we saw on Tuesday. It didn't take very long until Arbor Jack Eye had to account and had to stick up for himself for that hit that he laid on Tim
Stutzman. Yeah, I go back to a quote from Marty St. Louis that he said before the game started talking about Arbor Jack Eye. He said, I just want to see him play a full game, so... He goes into the game. He's definitely got a target on his back. But, he's trying to be physical, trying to keep his game. The physical part of this game, Gouley starts off with it early. Here's Jack Eye trying to be physical in the neutral zone. Now he has to answer to it. Gouley's trying to find his footing as well, too. He takes another big hit. But for Jack Eye, look, good for him. He had to know guys wanted him to answer for the other night with that big hit on Stutzla. I love this hit on Gouley. He's trying to get himself ready for the regular season. But... can somebody remind me, is this the regular season we're watching
now? It's not.
Because this preseason has been, unheard of with the penalties, the fights, the intensity. Some people love it. Some people are saying, get the regular season started. I'm one of the guys saying, get the regular season started so we can see this type of intensity when it comes.
We want the games to start for real.
Yes.
All right. Okay, well, for Montreal, yes, they had the shots advantage in that first period, 10-8 over Ottawa, but it took a while until they got one behind Linus Allmark, who was playing very good hockey as of late as well. How important was this one for Montreal?
Yeah, huge. You haven't had much going all period, and it starts in the D zone. It's a bad play by Batherson here. Gets too cute. But I love the neutral zone transition here, especially the entry where you get a wide pass to Dvorak. He tries to make make a play to the middle, but he doesn't give up on it. He wins the puck battle. Barboulet wins another puck battle. Gallagher does what he does best in and around the net. And Dvorak goes to the net and bangs one in. And this is huge for Montreal, where, you know, they didn't have much going on for the first 10 minutes of the game. They give up that power play goal to Pinto to put themselves back further, but they get a late goal. So you wonder, 20 minutes in the books, down 2-1. Hopefully the guys get their feet going again and finish this game on a strong note. Try to get that next one, because we talk about it being the preseason, but you still want to get a result.
And as you said, this preseason for Montreal has been filled of fights, injuries, and fines for the Montreal Canadiens. It has been eventful. And when our intermission continues, we'll hear from Gino Retta and Frankie Corrado on whether Montreal's bad blood with its rivals will carry over.
Around here with our two jobs and a teenager in school, our internet situation was getting kind of hairy.
No, I don't want to split hairs, hun, but it was a mess.
We were practically pulling our hair out.
We were totally at loose ends.
Then we found a solution that's permanent.
Bell Pure Fiber.
Now there's not a hair out of place. Right, honey?
Plus, we trimmed our expenses.
And to think we nearly missed it by a hair.
Fresh Stone Rollies, ready at any moment for real life moments. Loaded with your favorite flavors, Rollies keep you reaching for more. Share them, dip them, love them. Rollies, life rolled up.
There's regular colds, and then there's the mountains are blue cold. Mountain Cold Refreshment. Coors Light, the chill choice.
A new deal is at Tim's. $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich when you buy any size hot or iced coffee. You heard that right. Just $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich with Canada's favorite coffee. A $3 deal you won't want to miss.
It's time for Tim's.
They say dress for the job you want. Well, do we have some jobs for you? Now get purchase financing from 0% APR for up to 72 months.
Engineers don't just build things, they build solutions to make our lives better. From rethinking communities to make them more livable, to designing treatments that give hope to those facing disease, they build new ways to harness renewable energy to create a better tomorrow. And they make today brighter by sparking the confidence of a young child. Because that's what engineers do. They build hope for a better future for us all. Canada's engineers, building tomorrows.
This ship is heaven. There should be no guilt on a pleasure cruise. Doctor, it's your job to keep everybody alive.
No pulse.
She's in VFib. One, two, three. Clear.
I have a pulse.
You're gonna be okay.
I know what you need.
Dr. Oz. New episode Thursday, 9, 10 Mountain on CTV. Stream on all your favorite devices.
Laura, it's back.
Yes,
the second NFL international game is here, and the Jets and Vikings face off tomorrow in London, England. Coverage begins tomorrow at 9:30 Eastern, 10:30 a.m. Atlantic on TSN Plus.
He sold
it. I love all day football.
Ah, Carlo. Good stuff. All right. This is the second time in the last 5 days that the Senators and the Canadians are meeting. Yeah, we saw more of that rough stuff in the first period between these two. And what we've learned is it doesn't matter if it's the preseason, the regular season, or the playoffs. When you're rivals, you always bring that intensity and that fire. With more on Montreal's bad blood in this preseason, here's Gino Retta.
Alongside Frankie Corrado. Frankie, the Habs have had a wild preseason. Fines, fights, injuries. Their two biggest beefs with their two biggest rivals, the Leafs and the Sens. They happen to open the season with games against those two teams in the first week. Do you think this bad blood carries over into the games that really matter?
I do, Gino, and for a number of reasons. First and foremost, there's some stuff that happened in these games. The Patrick Laine incident, Kirby Doc getting hit by Ridley Gregg, Arbor Jacqueline answering back at Tim Stutzla. Like, specifically with the Ottawa games, that's a lot of regulars. That's a lot of guys that are going to be playing this season. So I can certainly see a lot of that carrying over into the regular season games. But aside from that, These are teams now that have different expectations. For the Ottawa Senators, they have a new head coach in Travis Green who's going to be hammering things home like we need to be a harder team to play against. The Montreal Canadiens want to take a step forward. And the Toronto Maple Leafs, under head coach Craig Berube, are going to be a different walking and talking team. Straight line hockey, more an emphasis on competitiveness and grit. So with all that being said, those expectations can lead to a little more of a chippy kind of game. And if expectations maybe aren't being met, that can lead to frustration. And what does frustration lead to? A little more of a chippy style of game. So I have no doubt, Gino, that these three teams are going to see a spillover of the chippiness that we saw in the preseason into the regular season.
Arbor Jack Eye has been right in the middle of a lot of the chaos. He's a player that spent time in the NHL and the American Hockey League last season. Do you think he makes this roster and contributes coming out of the gate with the Habs?
He probably does make the team, but he's made it harder on himself than he had to. He spent more time seemingly in the preseason not playing than he has playing. And coming out of last year, he did a really good job, Gino. When he came back from Laval, he looked comfortable. He looked settled in. It didn't seem like he was running around chasing the other aspects of the game. And now in this preseason, he's kind of chased those other aspects of the game. I don't doubt that he can settle down and find his game, but you have to look at a guy like Jaden Struble, who came up from Laval when Jack Eye got sent down. He's been a really stable force on the Montreal Canadiens blue line. There's other competition as far as those roster spots go on the Montreal Canadiens blue line. So I don't think it's clear cut that Arbor Jack Eye is going to be a top six defenseman on this team right away. He's going to be there, I would imagine, but there is more competition for that spot, especially playing on the third pair, and he's going to have to show that he can play the game, not just chase the other aspects around the game.
Do you think the Leafs should be inserting Ryan Reeves into the opening night lineup against the Habs to help police the situation?
It's a good question because, you know, we saw what happened last year. Arbor Jack Eye and Ryan Reeves, they get into a fight night one of the regular season. If you're going to make plans with your lineup based around what the other team may or may not do, you're kind of losing the plot a little bit. At the end of the day, like, you're trying to win a hockey game. You have to field the best team that gives you a chance to win the game. So if you feel like Ryan Reeves gives you a better chance to win that game, feel free. Put him in the lineup. You signed him for 3 years. You should feel that way about him. It shouldn't matter if they have Arbor Jack Eye in the lineup or not. There should be plenty of grit on the Leafs team anyways. So to answer your question, I wouldn't be surprised if Ryan Reeves is in the lineup because he's there. He's got two more years, and they think he's a part of the solution in Toronto. So yes, Ryan Reeves should be in the lineup against the Montreal Canadiens.
Leafs and Habs open up the regular season against each other on Wednesday night. Two games later, it's the Sens visiting the Bell Center on Saturday.
And Christian Dvorak getting a much-needed goal for the Canadiens with about a minute and a half to go in the period. It is 2-1 as we head to the second.
They say dress for the job you want. Well, do we have some jobs for you? Now get purchase financing from 0% APR for up to 72 months.
Support and play. 100% of donations support kids in local communities.
Whether you're at Raj's or Han's or Maria's, there's a Molson with your name on it. Canadian, XL, Ultra, Molson. Everyone in.
A new deal is at Tim's. $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich when you buy any size hot or iced coffee. You heard that right, just $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich with Canada's favorite coffee. A $3 deal you won't want to miss.
It's time for Tim's.
They say dress for the job you want. Well, do we have some jobs for you? Now get purchase financing from 0% APR for up to 72 months.
I love your building. Is anything for sale?
Oh, shut the front door. My son is in real estate. Andy DJs. And how are you fixed for supplements? He does it all.
RE/MAX agents don't stranger-splain. They explain with exactly the advice you need.
Buying a car is pretty daunting.
But the price badge on Auto Trader really gave me the confidence that I was putting my money to good use.
I think these features definitely boost the confidence.
The price badge is awesome.
The answer is Auto Trader.
The world ain't set up for the honest man to succeed. That's what they hire guys like me for.
I know who you are. I know what you are.
I'm an acquired taste.
You've really moved up in the world.
America's a hustle. It'll eat you alive if you let it. Not that I'm complaining.
Here's what's went down in that opening 20 minutes in Ottawa. The Shane Pinto Show with one and two goals, providing all the scoring for Ottawa, while Montreal's power play 0-for-2 in the first, bringing their total this preseason to 0-27, as we get you back now to Brian and JD.
Laura, I know it's the preseason, but we dug deep. Shane Pinto, Jamie, has never scored a hat trick in the NHL, NCAA, World Juniors, USHL, and World Men's. But you're saying there's a chance. Two goals and Pinto could get a hat trick tonight.
Mary Swanson, I love it. But you know what? I think there is a chance because he's been that good with the puck. And as we talked about before, only played half a season last year. Took him a bit to settle in, but he's a difference maker, and certainly Travis Green will be relying on him this season.
Jake Sanderson will throw it in deep for Ottawa. And there is the man of conversation, Pinto to the line. Tipped in front, score! Great tip in front of the net, and that is Amadio. He's got one. It's 3-1 Ottawa.
Again, another quick strike offense. This all starts off the forecheck. The Habs are back on their heels. They don't get the puck back. They don't win loose puck battles. It goes low to high. And when you've got a shot from the point, Artem Zub is just going to step a little bit to the middle. There's Pinto that pops it, and then it's just down to the front of the net. Now, in the high slot, Amadio gets available. The puck is shot about a foot and a half off the ice, and it's a beautiful little redirect that slides through Montembeau, exactly like Pinto's first goal of the game. We've got a 3-1 lead for the Ottawa Senators.
14 goals with Vegas last season, a strong preseason for Michael Amadio. He's fitting right in here on the nation's capital, putting some nice numbers up. And a 3-1 game here, second period underway. Jake Evans down low, Josh Anderson below the goal line, fighting off Norris. Anderson, far point, can't keep it in. And the foot race is on, good speed, bursting in. Noah Gregor couldn't get the shot off. Gregor back to work. Far circle, he'll go up top. That shot deflected, Norris. And just a touch of the glove, Montembeau able to keep that out.
Josh Norris with a nice little redirect in the high slot. That's one thing that I've noticed about the Senators. This might be a Travis Green effect, is you've got shots from the point and players in the high slot getting available to try and get sticks on him. And one of the best guys on the Ottawa Senators to do that is Brady Tkachuk. He's so good in that 10-foot radius. So just simple, smart hockey where you get it back to the point and shots to the front of the net.
Norris, three procedures on that shoulder. It's so nice to see him healthy and building some confidence here in the preseason, his second preseason game. And you talked about it with Gouley, timing and just getting your feel back in these games.
It's all about cadence, you know, going through habits so that they become habits where you're not thinking about it. You're not thinking the game, you're reacting. Same thing with Josh Norris, Caden Gouley, guys that are good players. It's about confidence and settling into that, where you just go out and play and you don't have to think out there.
Gapitan, little hit on Sanderson in the corner. Newhook goes to work, trying to dig it free for Montreal. Ottawa 3-0 in the regular season last year versus Montreal. Zach McEwen cutting in. Engstrom taken down. Montreal possesses the puck. Gignac able to move it ahead to center. There's Klevin back defensively. Gets it to Travis Hamonic. Havanek plays it up that right side. Cole Reinhart watching Engstrom closely. No icing. Levin will touch that off the boards to the left side. McEwen advances play to center. There's Pinto on the rush. That drive, Amadio right on, and a little late whack, and Pinto almost did it like he was expecting maybe a bit of a response, and now he'll get one.
Well, you can see right away. It took a little chop at the glove of Montembeau. This is a nice play by Cole Reinhart in the neutral zone to have a touch play to create this two-on-one. Noah Gregor had a nice little push in his previous shift to go hard towards the net, showing some speed. So the Senators group has kind of hit the ground running early in this second period, generating some chances. Gregor played for the Toronto Maple Leafs last year, and the guy's got tremendous speed. Be good on the penalty kill. You know, one of the big decisions for Travis Green and the management group, Steve Staios and Dave Poulin, is to figure out how things are going to fit heading into the regular season.
Gregor, a teammate in the Western League of Cade and Gooley. They both played in Prince Albert together. Arbor Jacki in his own zone. He'll sling it up the left side. Heinemann trying to whack that down. It comes to Jensen. He'll play it smoothly for Thomas Chabot. Chabot lifts one high to center for Ottawa. Logan Mayhew. Got it by Pinto for Dvorak and escapes to Heinemann. He'll poke it to Bray-Boulay. Heinemann takes a tumble. Jensen has the puck.
That's a nice little play there by Nick Jensen. Just a physical play, steps in, uses his body to separate player from puck, and now you're out of your zone. It's just a tiny detail that a veteran rear guard brings to the table.
Came in the deal in Washington, Jacob Chychrun. Here's a chance. Evans loads up, and Allmark, a good stop. As Evans and Allmark have had their own little one-on-one battles in this preseason. Evans has had some good chances Tuesday night and tonight as well. Pass in front. Oh, and a poked away just in time, or that would have been Noah Gregor with a great look in sight. Here's Gallagher the other way. And a penalty coming up. A hold. As Brendan Gallagher drawing a penalty, the Montreal Canadiens on the power play. Down by two as Zub will go to the box, and this is something Montreal, I mean, I get it, Jamie, it's not the regular Ottawa suspects. You don't have Suzuki, Slavkovsky, you don't have Cole Caulfield,
but
you got to get it going.
You do have to get it going. Special teams are the difference, especially with the parity in the National Hockey League. Now, here's the hold. Zub's going to wrap up. Reaches in with the right arm on Gallagher. But special teams with the parity in the National Hockey League are the difference between making the playoffs and not. If your special teams are good, it gives you an opportunity because it earns you extra points on any given night. And I would argue the penalty kill is more important because if you've got a strong penalty kill, then you can win one-goal games. Where there's other teams who have a strong power play, vis-a-vis a team like the Edmonton Oilers, when they got rolling on their 16-game streak, it was their penalty power play.
Look out! Pinto in! Backhand score! Patrick goal! Shane Pinto! The Ottawa fans knows what's up. Hats on the ice. Pinto's got his first.
It's almost like they heard you talking, Brian. He must have heard you talking, saying he's never gotten a hat trick. And our statistician, John Perlberg, was trying to find out when he's ever had a hat trick. Well, watch the turnover in the neutral zone, head up the whole way, gets Montembeau to bite. He's got the long reach, so he gets past the right pad that's outstretched. Awaits him, slides it in the open net for the hat trick goal here. With 15:14 left in the second period, it's been the Shane Pinto night so far, with his first hat trick for what seems like since he played in minor hockey, which is hard to believe. You and I, we were talking about it off air.
His skill set, I mean,
he's got such a tremendous skill set. You would have think at some point in high school hockey and college into the National Hockey League, he'd find three. Well, he's found three tonight here against the Canadiens and counting.
And Jamie, that's the trifecta, man. You got even strength, you got power play, you got shorthanded. So that's a working man's hat trick for Shane Pinto. 4-1 Ottawa. And again, we talked about the power play for Montreal. I mean, don't hurt yourself, and that's the thing. You want to try to get some good looks and feels going into the regular season as Ottawa comes again. Pass across for Norris. That was chipped away from him, and it's picked up by Barré-Boulet.
And you mentioned it's not the usual characters on the power play, but power play is still the power play. And if you're the Canadiens, 0 for 27 here in the preseason, you've got to find something to gravitate towards.
Here's Barron. Dvorak works it down low. Barré-Boulet. Dvorak waits, flips in front side of it. Anderson swinging a miss. He had a great look inside on Allmark. Logan Mailloux. Mailloux up top, Barron. Barré-Boulet. Mailloux just topped off his stick. And Jensen trying to power that puck out, and they will. And Jamie, at some point playing hockey coming up as youngsters, these players have all played on the power play.
Absolutely.
At some point, they have. Gallagher, dishes, in front, shot, blocked. And guess who? Jensen again. But it's not out. Barré-Boulet across. One-time drive. Allmark pushed across. Great save on Gallagher. Gallagher, wrister, missed the mark. Barré-Boulet. Gallagher one more time as Zub's out of the box. 5-on-5. Brendan Gallagher behind the net. He'll stop. Gallagher. And that drive high and over the net as it missed. And Dvorak will start a change.
Well, the Canadians with a couple decent looks there. Now, I think that hit the side of the net, but Allmark was right there with the right pad off the Gallagher offering. As he continues to be sharp.
Jake Evans over the blue line for Montreal. Just avoids the check from Chabot. There's McEwen. Reverses play into the corner. When you talk about special teams, the year in the bubble year Montreal went to the Cup Final, their penalty kill, Jamie, was in the 90s.
Yes.
The 90 percentile. So, I mean, it makes a massive difference when you get the special teams cooking one way or the other. There's McEwen. Wrist shot. Follow-up try. Both didn't get through. Ostapchuk takes contact. McEwen will start a change. Montreal trying to clear. Pezetta can't. He hits Ostapchuk. Back to Jacka. Arbor's brother Florian, also a Montreal Canadiens draft pick, and saw some time in the preseason as well. Florian Jacka, two big, strong customers as Artem Zub on Pezetta.
It's a big collision behind the net as Pezetta is a big guy, and Zub, no stranger to physicality.
That's a big part of Pezzetta's game every night to stay in the National Hockey League for Pezzetta. Allmark's going to glove that down and hold. Nearly 8 minutes gone here in the second period. It is the Pinto Show at Canadian Tire Center. Even strength, power play, shorthanded. He's got the hat trick.
Check this out. The phone is the key.
Like you, the redesigned Tucson doesn't stop. You got places to go and stories to tell.
Sleeping like a baby. Thank goodness for baby mode.
And with more than 9 out of 10 Tucson sold in the last decade still on the road, Wah keeps you going.
There's regular colds, and then there's the mountains are blue cold. Mountain Cold Refreshment. Coors Light. The chill choice.
Harvey's knows Canadians like things in threes, like hat tricks, football downs, the prairies, and now pickles. Thanks to our triple pickle poutine with deep fried and diced pickles and our creamy garlic dill sauce, it's a taste trifecta. Harvey's. It's a beautiful day.
Dash that.
that and more with DoorDash.
Shane Pinto with his first hat trick as a pro, and right from the drop of the puck tonight, he's been all over it. Turnover, shot towards the net, gets it past the left pad of Montembeau. A beautiful little redirect as Jake Sanderson throws it towards the net. He gets available with the stick, knocks it down, and then the turnover in the neutral zone, shorthanded, gets around Montembeau, and the hats were flying. Surprise. People, they want to throw their hats in the preseason. Keep the... as a souvenir, but Pinto has got three and counting. And right, if somebody decided to throw a blue suede shoe, I would know who it would be.
You know, Pinto had 9 points in 8 games at the Men's Worlds. And, you know, sometimes that experience can sort of give you some juice to build on for the regular season. You look at Sam Montembeau. He represented Canada a couple years ago, won the gold medal, was an outstanding goalie in the tournament, one of the best. And just builds you that confidence, that tournament sometimes.
It gives you the experience as well, too. You're right, the confidence playing against tough competition and having some success. Pinto's a guy that, you know, obviously missed half the season last year, felt that he didn't get the full season in and wanted to be a difference maker. Looks really sharp here in the preseason.
Logan Mailloux goes back, hit by Norris. That'll be another interesting battle to see who Marty St. Louis starts his top six on the blue line opening night versus Toronto at the Bell Center. And that young man's one of the guys in the battle. Logan Mailloux will start the play. Up for Dvorak. Barré Boulet look out off a stick and about 10 rows up here at Canadian Tire Center.
You mentioned the Habs defensive core. Caden Gooley's going to be a mainstay in the lineup. Got some young options. You know, Mailloux is a nice player that's up and coming. Does he need more seasoning? You know, Arbor Jacka is a guy that you know what he's going to bring to the table from a physicality standpoint, but is he going to be an everyday guy? You've got some veteran guys there. So, yes, it is a big decision for Marty St. Louis, and it's not going to be easy for them because you know that Austin Matthews and William Nylander and the Toronto Maple Leafs will be fired up for their opening game as well. And they're an offensive team, so you're going to have to be sharp defensively right on that opening night.
Well, Gooley, the left shot playing on his offside tonight, he's done that a lot in his young career as well, a lot of times with Mike Matheson. Here's Gaudette. He'll slide that to the right side, shot in. Cousins takes the body check. Arbor Jacka, in comes Cousins, and he hits Jacka, but... Cousins hit a wall there. He didn't move very much. Charber is a tough, big, young man. Here's Heinemann. Heading in. Wrist shot just wide, far side. Yannick trying to poke it free, and he will. Up the right side, McEwen with a stop check. In front, Ostapchuk couldn't get the shot off. Up for Sanderson. Big Sanderson creates some space. Wrist shot up high. Missed glove side. Well, I thought maybe the Michigan there was in sight,
it,
right? Yannick was kind of bobbling on him. Here's Sanderson at the line. He'll drop it off. Artem Zub. Yannick shoots, and he just missed short side. Sanderson, good job to hold his own. Heinemann hits him. Played around behind Montembeau. Past the midway point of the second period. 4-1 Ottawa. Ottawa trying to win their third straight preseason game for whatever that's worth, but you know, a little confidence never hurts. Winning feels good. In comes Chabot. Trudeau there, plays it away from him. It's funny, that Michigan play has become almost normal in the NHL with the skill set of these players. It's unbelievable. Here's Pinto, looking for four now. Already has the hat trick. Amadio plays catch, shoots right into Montembeau as Pinto, maybe not selfish there as he sent it across. It was a beautiful summer lake day, the nation's capital. A great look. Postcard there at Parliament Hill.
At Hyundai, our SUVs are a testament to everything we stand for. And everything SUV stands for. Solid. Unique. Versatile. Sturdy. Unmatched. valued. Safe, uncompromising, valiant. No wonder 94% are still on the road after 10 years. At Hyundai, we put the SUV in SUV, and we put the wow in wow.
Whether you're into pucks, or wickets, or red cards, there's a Molson with your name on it. Canadian, XL, Ultra, Molson. Everyone in.
A new deal is at Tim's. $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich when you buy any size hot or iced coffee. You heard that right. Just $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich with Canada's favorite coffee. A $3 deal you won't want to miss.
It's time for Tim's.
Paramount Plus.
We come to you from the mountain of entertainment to show you what's streaming on Paramount Plus. Blockbusters, like A Quiet Place, Day One. Originals, including Yellowstone.
I'm gonna let the world know we're here.
Light it up!
And hits like Dexter.
You're decent and good.
I'm not.
Paramount Plus, your eyeballs equals entertainment.
Stream Paramount Plus from $6.99 a month.
The future is bright for the Montreal Canadiens and their prospects, including Michael Hage, who was taken 21st overall in the draft in Vegas in the Sphere. Well, he made his debut at the University of Michigan. They lost the game, but he had two assists. He looked very comfortable. And you look at him, Ivan Demidov, who the Habs got fifth overall. He was the KHL Rookie of the Month, as well as Demidov has been looking fantastic in St. Petersburg with limited ice time, I should put in as well. So, yeah, these two first-round picks, a lot of excitement in Montreal for these two young men.
The future is bright, certainly, and we've talked about some of the young players that are close to cracking the lineup. They've done a very good job restocking the shelves in Montreal. But now the challenge is to get to that next level where expectations are to make the playoffs. I'm not sure if that's the mantra this year. But it would be nice to be playing meaningful hockey in March if you're the Montreal Canadiens and have some of these young players that push through.
And two young defensemen who I can't wait to watch in the NHL on both sides, Yakimchuk and Hudson.
Yes.
I mean, Yakimchuk, what, 7 points in 4 games in the preseason? Had 30 goals in the Western League. Unbelievable numbers. And Lane Hudson, my goodness, he looks destined to maybe start opening night in a Montreal Canadiens jersey. Not to put words in Marty St. Louis' mouth or anything, but man, Lane Hudson is as advertised. He just has a toolbox that not a lot of players have.
I think it would be tough to keep him out of the lineup. That's the biggest challenge for the Montreal Canadiens. If you're drafting, if you're developing, you're allowing young players to push through. Ottawa's got the same, we'll call it problems. It's not problems. You've got decisions to make. Yakimchuk's a guy that I think is close to playing in the National Hockey League, but there's no decision to, there's no option to put him in the AHL. That's what's unfortunate.
Arbor Jacki wrist shot loose, and Allmark finds it with a glove. As Newhook captain right there, looking for any rebound.
This is the one thing about I like about Linus Allmark. Is he's a big goaltender who covers the ice really well. So he does a good job of finding this puck through traffic. And the minute you do that, then he fights for the rebound. Lost puck battle. Down low, Jacki's going to get the middle of the ice. And look at the positioning of Allmark. Out, square, set. Gets hit with the puck and then is able to gobble up that rebound. That's impressive from the veteran goaltender.
Oliver Kapanen lining up. So if Kapanen doesn't make the team, he'll actually go back to Europe in the SHL for Team Raw. And Olli Jokinen just signed a deal to be the head coach there, so he'll be under the tutelage of Olli Jokinen. If he indeed doesn't crack the roster, he won't go to Laval. He'll go back to Europe.
My old teammate, Olli, in Florida. Done a good job over there in Finland, becoming a very good coach.
Logan Mailloux at the line, wrist shot, hit a body, and it trickled to Allmark. He'll steer it aside as Kapanen races after it. In comes Newhook. Alex Newhook battling for the puck. There's another guy that the Habs are hoping takes another step this season in Newhook.
Well, if he could stay healthy, he's a guy who I think is a really good player. And, you know, he's skilled, he's quick, got great vision. Kirby Dach, like guys like that who didn't have great seasons last year because of injury and inconsistency. Now that's what the Canadians are hoping for, is that internal growth.
Dach not in the lineup, but he did score in back-to-back preseason games. Took that hit from Ridley Gregg Tuesday at the Bell Center. Returned, though, and then scored. Look out, the stick played shattered for Hamonic, but he alertly grabs him from the bench, puck all the way to Allmark, and Hamonic, new stick, he'll play it. Levitt lost it. Look out in front. Chinyak looking for it, and the big reach and paddle of Allmark got in the way.
An aggressive play by Allmark. It was a backdoor option. He didn't allow that to get to the backdoor as he took a step out from his net. That's a terrific heads-up play by the goaltender. Aggressive, though, as you mentioned.
Brandon Chinyak trying to make an impact. Under six to go here in this second period. Shots 14-13 in favor of Ottawa, and they have a three-goal cushion right now. There's Pinto. He'll hand it off. Yannick, great shot, and that deflected just wide. Amadio, good screen in front. Pinto, he gets taken down, stick handling. And a penalty coming up as Condotta lost his stick. Extra attacker out as Allmark gets to the bench. Here's Shabbat. Pinto. Yannick. Hands it off. Pinto. Assessing options. Goes to the point. Jensen back to Pinto. Yannick. Space. Shoots. Stop Montembeau. Yannick back on it. He'll play it up top. Shabbat across. One side. Big block. And that one stung. Right in the leg of Engstrom. And he's still hurting from that block. Long time with the extra attacker as Norris. Jensen. He bombs one, misses everything. Pinto, below the goal line, keeps it alive. Here's Norris. Amadio, cross ice shot. Oh, Montembeau pushed across. And a great save as Montembeau, a must make in this game. Ottawa on the power play when we come back to Canadian Tire Center.
Whether you're into pucks or wickets or red cards, there's a Molson with your name on it. Canadian XL Ultra Molson. Everyone in.
Around here with our two jobs and a teenager in school, our internet situation was getting kind of hairy.
No, I don't want to split hairs, hun, but it was a mess.
We were practically pulling our hair out.
We were totally at loose ends.
Then we found a solution that's permanent.
Bell Pure Fiber.
Now there's not a hair out of place. Right, honey?
Plus, we trimmed our expenses.
And to think we nearly missed it by a hair.
Fresh Stone Rollies, ready at any moment for real-life moments. Loaded with your favorite flavors, Rollies keep you reaching for more. Share them, dip them, love them. Rollies, life rolled up.
And this, you're using Head & Shoulders, right?
Only when I see flakes.
You should use it every wash, otherwise the flakes will come back.
He's right, you know.
Is that Tiny Troy?
There's no itchiness, dryness, or flakes down here.
I love Tiny Troy.
Make every wash count.
Shopping for a car was super stressful, I'm not gonna lie.
But with Auto Trader, you have options.
To set criteria for mileage, for price.
Any make, any year, any budget.
And walk away with a great deal.
The answer is Auto Trader.
There's Lucas Condotta in the box. Ottawa 1-for-2 in the power play, Jamie, with three shots tonight.
Another opportunity for the Sens to work on the power play, move the puck around. Shane Pinto looking for his fourth goal. I would argue he's probably going to be in that bumper position. But there's the penalty as Pinto tries to get to middle ice, taken down. Tough to argue that call. And then Engstrom takes that shot off the left foot. Stung him, seemed to be no worse for wear, but he's going to feel that tomorrow morning as he wake up with a sore foot. But Sens looking for their setup here on the power play as Jake Sanderson's going to quarterback it.
Ottawa 7-for-30 in the preseason, just over 23% on the power play. Noah Gregor lost it, gets it back. He'll dish to Sanderson, who walks the line. Sanderson for Batherson. Blake Batherson throws it for Norris. Just missed him. There's Arbor Jacki. And Christian Dvorak has the puck shorthanded for Montreal. Dvorak away with Anderson. And good job, Dvorak. He'll kill off some more time in the corner for his team. And there are four to go in this second period. Dvorak, the lone goal for Montreal in this game. A couple for him in the preseason. Here's a chance for Justin Barron, using his wheels around Sanderson. Barron shorthanded, backhand try. Ran out of real estate, and Allmark stayed with him.
Barron's a really good skater. Jake Sanderson's one of the better skaters in the league, and Barron showing some speed through the neutral zone takes Sanderson wide, and then Sanderson's able to wedge him off into a tougher angle. That made it easier for Allmark to seal the post.
Well, Carlo and Laura talked about it. One of those battles at defense, and Barron in the middle of that battle as well. And Barron does have to go through waivers for Montreal. Adam Gaudette will throw it in for Ottawa. Arbor Jacki takes a look. Up for Nick Cousins. Cousins to the point. Thomas Chabot. Gaudette. Waiting, wrist shot, hit a body, went wide as Arbor Jacki to the puck first. Jacki able to clear to center. Shot back in by Adam Gaudette to Montembeault. And just one shot on that man advantage. Game remains 4-1. 2:15 to go in this second frame. Here's Newhook with Kapanen. Kapanen, Newhook, trying to get it back to him. And broken up nicely by the veteran Hamonen. The stop shot up the left side. He's pinned off the puck. Trudeau lost it in the corner. Yannick behind the net. He'll try to curl away from Barron. Yannick with McEwen. McEwen around the boards. Levin throws it across. Hamonic's drive hits the glass, stays in play. Alex Newhook at his own blue line for the Habs. A little chip up ahead for Kapanen. Joshua Waugh racing after it. Engstrom. Caden Gooley. Newhook. Seam pass across to the skates of Gallagher. Couldn't get the shot off. Newhook using the boards. Try to get it to the blue line and the puck at center. And Ottawa comes away. Norris some pace. Norris cutting in forehand just wide. And that would be a pretty good feel-good story if Josh Norris could cash one here in the preseason.
Absolutely. A little burst of speed there. For him, as you mentioned before, it's all about confidence. Being able to give hits, receive hits, just feel normal out in the ice where you can get in some cadence and try and work your magic. He's got a great shot. He's got good speed, good skill. It's all about timing now.
58 games for Norris over the last two seasons. Gallagher to the forehand. Still working. Banging away, Brendan Gallagher. Had a couple 30-goal seasons. Did number 11. He was the heart and soul of this team. And the oldest standing Metter. And there's William Trudeau into the lineup tonight. Getting a look in front of Martin St. Louis.
Trying to make one last impression. We talked about some young players. You get some games in the preseason to try and win over some trust. There's usually one or two players out of training camp that will surprise, where the coach will give them more and more responsibility as you go along. Now, can you handle the rigors the day-to-day of National Hockey League? Early on, you run on adrenaline. Afterwards, you've got to settle in. And some players can handle it. Some players kind of get pushed to the side. So we'll see how the big decisions on both sides are made here after tonight's game.
Dvorak wanted Logan Mailloux off his skate. Ottawa flips the center. Pinto got taken down by Jacki. Here's Barré-Boulet. Seam pass across. Mailloux fanned on the shot and cleared again to center. There's 5 seconds left. Montreal's going to get back on side. Time will wind down. 40 minutes done. 20 minutes left. Oh, Pinto. The late hit on Mailloux and Jacki right there. It's been that kind of preseason for the Montreal Canadiens.
Shane Pinto not taking his foot off the gas. And now that got a reaction from Jack Eye. This could have been an easy drive-by for Shane Pinto with a half a second left, but decided he wanted to be physical on the play. Showing a little bit of bite here as he's got a hat trick underneath his belt after two periods. It's been a solid performance by the Senators. They have a commanding lead 4-1 heading into the third period.
Pinto's got three. Amadio's got a goal. And the lone goal for the Montreal Canadiens coming from Christian Dvorak. 20 minutes of preseason hockey remains at Canadian Tire Center on this Saturday night. Intermission next with Laura, Carlo, and Claire.
There's regular colds. And then there's the mountains are blue cold. Mountain Cold Refreshment. Coors Light. The chill choice.
Around here with our two jobs and a teenager in school, our internet situation was getting kind of hairy.
No, I don't want to split hairs, hon, but it was a mess.
We were practically pulling our hair out.
We were totally at loose ends.
Then we found a solution that's permanent.
Bell Pure Fiber.
Now there's not a hair out of place. Right, honey?
Plus, we trimmed our expenses.
And to think we nearly missed it by a hair.
They say dress for the job you want. Well, do we have some jobs for you? Now get purchase financing from 0% APR for up to 72 months.
A new deal is at Tim's. $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich when you buy any size hot or iced coffee. You heard that right. Just $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich with Canada's favorite coffee. A $3 deal you won't want to miss.
It's time for Tim's.
Whether you're into pucks or wickets or red cards, there's a Molson with your name on it. Canadian XL Ultra Molson. Everyone in.
When I was just a little girl, I asked my mother, what will I be? Will I be pretty? Will I?
He did it again.
Yeah, poor guy.
Wow. No! Oh.
Isn't that our cleaning lady?
Not today.
You know how when you're living your life, and then all of a sudden you're out there helping cops solve crimes?
How do you do that?
I have an IQ of 160, so that might have something to do with it. You want me to go in there and flip the table over?
No, I do not.
Look.
We're really doing this, huh?
We're doing it.
High Potential, Tuesday at 10, 8 Mountain on CTV. Stream on all your favorite devices.
It's that time of the year again. Haven't heard this music for a long time. The Raptors will tip off their first game of the preseason tomorrow. It comes at the Bell Center in Montreal against the Wizards. We've got coverage for you at 7:30 Eastern Time, 8:30 Atlantic here on TSN. Well, the Senators a period away from wrapping up their preseason schedule with a third straight win. Let's get it over to Claire now, who's standing by with Nick Jensen.
Nick, you guys are up 4-1 in the second period. Just tell me what's going right for your team so far.
I think that period we got a little bit to work in the O-zone. We had good D-zone in the first, but we spent a little too much time in the D-zone. I think this time we got the puck in, got to work, put a little pressure on them, and I think they're starting to feel it.
What's it like playing in front of a goaltender like Linus Ullmark?
It's easy because, I mean, obviously we want to defend well, but when you know pucks are getting back there, he's making those big saves. It's really confident for your decor as a group, as a group of five. So it's great having him back there.
This is your last preseason game with the Ottawa Senators, your first year with this organization. What tone are you trying to set as a veteran that's coming into this team?
Yeah, like I said before, it's just like that hard work, competitiveness, bringing that every night. I think guys can really get behind that. They see guys doing that on the ice, and they want to follow that. So that's kind of what the tempo I'm trying to set right now, and I think it's been going pretty good for our group so far.
Thank you, Nick.
Yeah, thank you.
Nick Jensen, solid piece they added on the back end.
Big time veteran presence, right?
I like that move a lot.
And the thing with the Senators, too, we've seen it over the last few seasons, they're notorious slow starters, right? So the fact that they could be winning their third straight game here heading into the regular season is a good thing for them.
And that's such a good point, Laura. I mean, think about the hole they've had to dig out of every season, right? I mean, it's tough to... You know, tough to play good, but when you got to always fight for your life early on in the season, that's probably why they haven't had, you know, playoff success or even close to it.
Couple goals there for them in that second period with a 4-1 lead, and it was another quick goal. We saw the first goal of the game 44 seconds in, 22 seconds in, and although it wasn't Shane Pinto that scored the goal, I mean, it's a pretty good combo that he's setting now with Michael Amadio.
It really is, and, you know, it's another carbon copy of the start for the Montreal Canadiens. Slow start, and the puck ends up in the back of their net, and this line has been on fire all night. The Pinto, Amadio, and Yannick line have created chances all over the ice. Love the puck protection by Pinto here. He's really, really showing himself to be a player that Ottawa can count on this year. And Amadio is just a solid veteran. Gets to the front of the net, he's a benefactor. And then there's Pinto. Two goals on the night already on the penalty kill. You can see he wants this one really bad. Someone's got to tell him the preseason goals don't count in the regular season. Save him for the regular season. But other than that, three on the night. He's been one of the stars of the game, 4 points. Those two guys together have been really good. And when you look at this Ottawa lineup, you know, you got Norris, Stützle, Pinto down the middle. It's a great start for them, and it's going to be each one of those guys is going to be pushing for more opportunity.
The Sens definitely winning the special teams battle here tonight as well. A power play goal, a shorthanded goal, an issue that Montreal had a season ago as they were tied for the league lead and giving up the most shorthanded goals. The power play, continues to be a major issue. And again, I know we say it's the preseason, but this is the time where you're working out the kinks, you're building chemistry, and now they're 0-28 with a man advantage.
Yeah, that's a hard one to swallow if you're Montreal, because you're right, it is the preseason. You don't want to overreact, but you also want to be feeling good about the guys you throw out to the power play, or at least the system that you're trying to preach on the power play. And I'm still trying to figure out what that is, because going back to last year, one of the league's worst power play, didn't do enough to generate pucks towards the net. And here, you can see in a couple chances they have. I know they don't have the A group on, but it's a lot of perimeter stuff, a lot of bouncing passes, a lot of fumbled pucks. They've got to understand that you got an extra guy on the ice. You got to make clean plays. You got to make efficient plays. And you got to get more pucks to the net. It's sometimes the first ones aren't always going to go in, but it's the second and third chances you got to create with net traffic in front of the net. And you got to outwork and outmuscle the guys on the penalty kill. Haven't seen enough of that tonight. Haven't seen enough of it throughout the preseason, even when their top guys are going, look, again, it's the preseason, but Marty St. Louis and his coaching staff definitely has to change whatever mojo that they've created with their power, it's just not good enough.
Right. Is it personnel? Is it the system? But the regular season just around the corner. And yes, in Prague, it's already well underway. We'll have highlights of the second Global Series game between the Devils and Sabres next.
Check this out. The phone is the key.
Like you, the redesigned Tucson doesn't stop. You got places to go and stories to tell.
Sleeping like a baby. Thank goodness for baby mode.
And with more than 9 out of 10 Tucson's sold in the last decade still on the road, Wah keeps you going.
A new deal is at Tim's. $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich when you buy any size hot or iced coffee. You heard that right. Just $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich with Canada's favorite coffee. A $3 deal you won't want to miss.
It's time for Tim's.
Whether you're into pucks or wickets, or red cards, there's a Molson with your name on it. Canadian, XL, Ultra, Molson, everyone in.
My life is full of questions.
Mom, is yellow a light or a dark?
How do I clean an aioli stain?
Thankfully, Tide's the answer to almost all of them.
Why do we even buy napkins?
Drink cold water, clean white socks.
It can with Tide.
Do I need to pre-treat guacamole?
No, with Tide.
This is chocolate, right?
Just use
Tide? Yeah.
No matter who's doing it, on what cycle, or in what temperature, Tide works. So I can focus on all the other questions.
Do crabs have eyebrows?
For all of life's laundry questions, it's got to be Tide.
At Hyundai, our SUVs are a testament to everything we stand for. And everything SUV stands for. Solid. Unique, versatile, sturdy, unmatched, valued, safe, uncompromising, valiant. No wonder 94% are still on the road after 10 years. At Hyundai, we put the SUV in SUV, and we put the wow in wow.
Sunday.
He'll throw it to Henry.
It's NFL on TSN and CTV.
Touchdown number 2 for number 22.
Jackson and the Mighty King face the division rival Bengals.
Wow.
Allen and the Bills dust off to tackle the Texans.
Stephon Diggs.
Then the Cards fly into Niners territory.
He ripped it away.
On Sunday Night Football, Prescott versus the Steelers D. It all starts at 1 Eastern. See every touchdown every Sunday with NFL Red Zone on TSN Plus.
The NASCAR Cup Series is making a stop at the Talladega Super Speedway in Lincoln, Alabama for the Yellowwood 500. Gotta love NASCAR. You can tune in tomorrow at 1:30 Eastern, 2:30 p.m. Atlantic on TSN for coverage of the NASCAR Cup Series. So, yes, while we are all patiently awaiting the start of the regular season, they got things started early over in Prague this past weekend. The Sabres and the Devils.
They gave us a taste. Hey, hey. Regular season's here.
And, you know, for us, the games were starting nice and early. A good way to start your day off there. And, you know, they had the star-studded fans in attendance as well. Jaromir Jagr, Nick Lidstrom, and there. Yep.
Patrick Elias. People say I look like him.
Well, there you go. How did you get back here so fast then, Carlo? Here in the first, J.J. Paterka upended by Brendan Dillon. Paterka shaken up. That would lead to the first fight of this regular season. That one between Alex Tuck and Dillon. As for Paterka, you can see, needed some help getting off the ice. Did not return out with an upper body injury. We are waiting the game's first goal here, Carlo. We're in the second period. Tuck throws it on net. Paige Thompson knows what to do after that.
You know what? Buffalo needs a big year to Tage Thompson. Guy scored almost 50 the year before. I love a little bit of a down year. They gave him the big contract. Buffalo's going to go as far as their top players take them, so they got to start the season off good.
He's on the board, but now in the third, as you can see, it's all tied when Jack Hughes goes to work. Ooh. Paul Cotter going roof.
Wow.
Cotter's starting.
Cotter or coffee?
Cotter. Yeah, he starts his first season with the Devils.
Leg kicking everything.
Goals in back-to-back games. As Jersey goes in front, later in the frame, we get our insurance goal. Yes, for Bratt. Around the net, Timo Meier. The Devils score 3 straight, wrapping up the Global Series with a clean sweep, back-to-back wins to start the season.
Nice gift for Meier there. Hey, go to the net, tap in an empty netter, doesn't get any better. See, I told you, look at me, look at Elia.
We got to do a split screen here. So Sheldon Keefe, a pretty good start to his tenure as Devils head coach, 2 straight wins. Jacob Markstrom, Jake Allen were sensational here as they gave up just 2 goals total. The Buffalo power play, I know we're not in Montreal territory, 0 for 6. Although, as we said, that is the regular season, not the preseason. But always great to get the hockey going nice and early, especially overseas. This is the 11th time that we're seeing games over in Europe.
As if the Devils didn't enjoy their 0-2 start. Their Twitter team had to post the 0-2 arena, which is what the arena was called, and put the Sabres logo in the 0 as they start 0-2 in the season. Man, these Twitter teams are getting ruthless with each other early in the season.
Mid-season form.
You know, talking about a series in Europe, it's always fun. It's better to get out of the way early in the season so that you can come back and get acclimated back to the normal schedule of what the season is. But you never want to leave there winless.
Yes.
And so, especially for the Buffalo Sabres, they got a new coach in this year with Lindy Ruff. They're hoping for things to change over there, maybe talk about playoffs, but to lose the first 2 games, it's a long flight home now. You have to think about it even more. It's a long time again before you play your next game. You wonder how much is going to affect how the rest of their season goes, but they got to find a way to get back in the win column as soon as possible when they get back to North America. But for the Devils, an amazing start.
They're not going to want to leave Prague. They're like, we'll stay here.
An amazing start for them. Nobody wants to leave Prague, that's for sure. Amazing start for them with new coach Sheldon Keefe. Looks like he's getting them playing at the top of their game. They were flying those 2 games. They saw the skill. You saw the speed. You saw the goaltending, that save that Markstrom made in game 1. A lot going well for the Devils. Off to a good 2 start. And an early Stanley Cup favorite when you talk about the FanDuel odds, too.
There you go. You got it all in there, Carlo. Patrick Elias. let's go to
Carlo Elias.
They say dress for the job you want.
Well, we have some jobs for you. Now get purchase financing from 0% APR for up to 72 months.
A new deal is at Tim's. $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich when you buy any size hot or iced coffee. You heard that right. Just $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich with Canada's favorite coffee. A $3 deal you won't want to miss.
It's time for Tim's.
Fresh Stone Rollies, ready at any moment for real life moments. Loaded with your favorite flavors, Rollies keep you reaching for more. Share them, dip them, love them. Rollies, life rolled up.
Whether you're at Raj's or Han's or Maria's, there's a Molson with your name on it. Canadian, XL, Ultra, Molson, everyone in.
They say dress for the job you want. Well, we have some jobs for you. Now get purchase financing from 0% APR for up to 72 months.
A new deal is at Tim's. $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich when you buy any size hot or iced coffee. You heard that right. Just $3 for a classic breakfast sandwich with Canada's favorite coffee. A $3 deal you won't want to miss.
It's time for Tim's.
I love your building. Is anything for sale?
Oh, shut the front door. My son is in real estate. Andy DJs. And how are you fixed for supplements? He does it all.
RE/MAX agents don't stranger-splain. They explain with exactly the advice you need.
Toyo Observe GSI 6 winter tires with micro:bit technology stick to just about anything.
Who's guilty of the best performance?
There are clues everywhere.
Is it an athlete in the Buffalo costume with the 80s hit?
Who is it?
Is it a supermodel in the Showbird feathers with an R&B bop? Is it a movie star in the Wasp outfit with a dance song? Get a clue.
We need more clues.
And find out.
Oh, my goodness!
An all-new Masked Singer. Wednesday at 8, 9 Mountain on CTV. Stream next day on Crave.
One more period to go in preseason action for the Sens and the Habs. Ottawa with the 4-1 lead, and with their thoughts on what we've seen so far tonight at the Canadian Tire Centre, it's back to Brian and Jean.
Laura, the year that Cole Caufield won the Hobie Baker for top college player in NCAA, Shane Pinto was a top three finalist. Pinto also scored his first ever National Hockey League goal against the Montreal Canadiens, and again tonight, an impact versus Montreal.
He certainly has been an impactful player, and it's well documented. He missed half a season last year. He wanted to hit the ground running. Said he had a good offseason as far as working out, and his mindset was coming in to be an impact player. Well, he certainly has done that for the Ottawa Senators, especially in these first two periods. Scored a couple goals, really three goals, all different ways. You're shorthanded, power play, 5-on-5, but he's got a long reach, he's got tremendous skill, he's a difference maker, and now strength down the middle of the ice. Josh Norris is playing tonight, you're going to have Tim Stützle, and you're going to have Shane Pinto, three guys who are young, they're skilled, they're fast, they can be involved in the play. They want to be difference makers, and it's versatility for Travis Green down the middle of the ice.
Matthew Highmore out with an upper body injury, who will not return tonight's hockey game. Laura.
Yes, the Shane Pinto party continued into the second period. A goal and a helper for him as he is having a career night. Shorthanded goal to boot. The shots are all tied up 17 apiece as this is the final period of the preseason. And back again to the Canadian Tire Centre, Brian and Jean.
No whistles.
Running clock. Steve Staios and Dave Poulin said one of the biggest priorities was goaltending. And Jamie, they got it. They traded Korpisalo, Pastelic, and a first-round pick to acquire Linus Ullmark. And my goodness, he has looked dynamite in the preseason thus far.
He certainly has. And for me, obviously, if he can stay healthy this season, the biggest question mark will be how many games is Ullmark going to play? Does it have something with a 5 in it? Is it 55, 53? Just keep in mind, Anton Forsberg can give more than backup minutes. So if you have a healthy tandem that pushes each other, that bodes well for the organization. And I think that's what you're hoping for, and head coach Travis Green is hoping for, is he can go back and forth with these guys and allow them to have a healthy competition in the net and push each other.
Forsberg last year was 15-12-0. 30 games played for the Ottawa Senators. I remember him and Swayman, they were a tandem and the best tandem in the NHL for a number of years in Boston.
Absolutely, and I think that's what made Ullmark really effective is that, you know, you battled for his starts, but he also had some starts where he spaced out so he could be well-rested.
There's Sanderson. Backhand pass, Pinto, high wrist shot over the glove and net. Montembeau was ready. Who's been your biggest, nicest surprise on Ottawa's camp thus far? We'll start with the Ottawa Senators.
Well, you know, a stop check for me, I wouldn't say surprise, but I really like how good of a player he is. He's just very, very, I think he's responsible. And you know, coaches look for that with players that are going to play farther down in your lineup. And he's a young guy.
Here's Newhook. Newhook back on the puck. Up top. Here's Arbor Jack guy. That wrister hit Kapanen just wide. Play behind the net. Barré-Boulé was hoping for the pass from Newhook in front. Mayu gets checked by Batherson, and Batherson clears the center.
Just to finish my thought on a stop check, he's a young guy, and a lot of times it takes guys a little bit longer to settle in and work away from the puck. A stop check has that responsibility, and he was a big guy. He could fight. He could kind of do it all. So I think, I wouldn't say biggest surprise, but, you know, I think he's a guy who's pushing to be in the opening night lineup or to be on the team. And Travis Green's got some big decisions to make, as well as Dave Poulin and Steve Staios and his management group, Ryan Bonus.
Ostapchuk got 7 games in the NHL last year as Heinemann trying to make a late impact during this third period. Here's Gaudette, little chip and chase. In comes Cousins as well. Nick Cousins to the puck first. Backhand dish, Hamonic. He'll play it across. Plevin. Throws it to space. Gaudette picks it up. Adam Gaudette. Plevin. Hamonic. He'll dish it in. William Trudeau. Trying to bat that away, and he will, and Montreal controls. Emil Hanneman to the right side for Dvorak. He's with Joshua Waugh. Waugh. Dvorak got clipped, all tied up, and Waugh couldn't find him with that return feed. And on the Montreal side, who's caught your eye, Jamie?
I mean, Lane Hutson, obviously.
Yeah.
I mean, when you look at what he's capable of, I think you and I were trying to temper expectations, right? Like, because I think you and I, we were chatting earlier, I want him in the opening night lineup. I want him to be a difference maker opening night. And I think he's capable of doing that, but it's a lot of responsibility for a young guy. And the fan base is loving him right now, and he's a special player.
Caden Gooley wrist shot and handled by Ullmark. Played 2 games, both versus Detroit. Had an assist in each game and helped Slavkovsky get his bonus, setting up that 20th goal. That drive, and Condotta fanned on it. Couldn't get the shot away clean on Ullmark. Here's Gooley again. Nice move, Caden Gooley. He'll walk it in deep for Montreal. Brad Injignac. He'll wait. Pops free. That drive stops. As Gooley fell, couldn't get a good shot away. Injignac's going to hold his own. Ostapchuk watching him. Jake Evans. Waits. Anderson shoots, and that hit a body rebound. The body was Pezzetta, and he couldn't find it in his case to get a clean shot off. And the Habs were changing on the fly to get some fresh legs out.
Good push here early in the third period by the Habs, trying to get some offensive zone time. Get to the middle of the ice to try and test the goaltender.
Nice move, Evans. He'll gain the zone for Montreal. Josh Anderson chasing after Jensen in the puck. Michael Amadio in for Ottawa. Takes play into the corner. Evans able to clean up the puck. He'll backhand that to Arbor Jacka. Turnover. Picked up, though, by Logan Mayu. Arbor Jacka there to help. Amadio, strong game. Pass in front. And he had Pinto looking for goal number 4. Brendan Gallagher. He'll stop along the boards, passes it off, Kapanen, try to get it to the forehand and get that shot off. Barré-Boulé lost the puck in the corner as Gregor plays it away from him. Montreal had a nice few days in Tremblant, some team building, and then drove straight here for the game. to wrap up their preseason.
Nothing wrong with that. A little team bonding. Enjoy yourself. Maybe there's some golf involved. Get to get away from the rink and just allow the body to relax. And as you mentioned, some team bonding as well. So it looks like we're going to have a...
Too many men?
Too many men penalty.
They had a great time at the President's Cup in Montreal. Internationals versus the Americans. The Montreal Canadiens got a lot of fun there. Royal Montreal watching and participating.
Too many men on the ice.
So too many men penalty. That'll be served by Drake Batherson. So Montreal, here we go. Marty St. Louis, who's taking over power play duties this year, by the way. Alex Burrow stepping back a little bit, still with the organization, working with Paul Byron in a player development role.
I think the best thing for the Canadians is if Marty could jump on, put his skates on,
yeah,
and actually play.
Yes.
On the power play. He was a power play specialist. And I was actually going to say that when we were talking about the stats 0 for 27 on the power play. It must actually bother the head coach because of the way that he played and how talented he was. Guaranteed he's going to work to change that.
It's funny though, right? You talk about Wayne Gretzky. He was a head coach in the NHL, but what Wayne could see and do, you can't teach necessarily all the time. I mean,
my good buddy Tyson Nash played for him, and he said he would look back and Gretzky just be staring at him. What are you doing?
It's just, I mean,
which is tough because you've got the greatest player of all time as your coach, and you're out there chopping the puck up, and he's staring at you as you skate off. He said, it's very intimidating.
Well, you talk about skill sets you can't teach. I mean, that's Lane Hudson. I mean, his vision, his creativity, how he sees the game, it's a special, unique talent that Lane Hudson has.
It is, and you're right. You throw in talent and then work ethic and them settling in with confidence at the NHL level. On a different scale, I would argue, and I can't prove this, that Ilya Sorokin with the Islanders had probably had some problems with Patrick Waugh standing back there behind the bench because they haven't seen eye to eye, and he hasn't played great for Patrick yet. But same thing, Patrick's arguably one of the best goaltenders of all time. He's probably sitting there behind the bench staring at his goaltenders.
And we got a delay of game, so the Montreal Canadiens puck over glass, delay of game. And Montreal has an opportunity here. 42 seconds of 5-on-3. Noah Gregor to the box.
Ottawa number 73. 2-minute minor penalty for delay of game.
Hard to argue that. And puck over glass. And now this power play gets a little bit more space in the offensive zone to move it around.
So that one of the rule changes, too, you can actually challenge if maybe that deflected off something this year. A coach can challenge it.
I don't
it.
Mind that, though. I don't. I think people get to a point where it's like, okay, we just want to get it right. But then what is the line of getting it right? I still think it's a... There's a puck over the glass, too. I'm not going to challenge that one. But I think it comes back to the argument, and we see it every Sunday with NFL football, is, you know, what is pass interference, and goaltender interference, the same thing. When it comes subjective to opinion, now you start getting in some trouble.
Montreal controls. Trying to get their first on the power play to wrap up the preseason here. Third period. Barron loads up right on. Rebound in front. Reaching Dvorak, and Allmark keeps it out. You mentioned Marty St. Louis. Jamie, 101 career power play goals in his time. And Hall of Famer. What a player Marty was.
Unbelievable.
Mayhew, good velocity one-timer. Allmark stops that. Logan Mayhew waiting. Rister, deflection. Dvorak again in front. A good redirect, but Allmark's been sharp.
What an unbelievable read by Linus Allmark on that play. It was a great redirect, but Allmark pushed from right to left to get the body in front of it.
Batherson out of the box, so now it's 5-on-4 for a minute eight. And Ottawa pumps the puck into Montreal territory, picked up by Adam Engstrom. Engstrom weaving through center. Joshua Waugh rips it back. There's Alex Newhook. Nick Suzuki led the team across the board. Power play goals, goals, points last year. Setting career highs, did the captain. And look out, Montembeau's got to come out. As a stop check was racing in. Allmark's going to slap it himself, and he'll clear it to center.
Don't mind a goaltender taking a slap shot down the ice.
Well, he scored a goal, remember, Jamie?
Yes, he handles the puck very well. He's very confident with the puck.
We were chatting if you'd ever scored one, and the answer was no.
Nope, I tried to go for one in the minors, a cross-corner dump. I grabbed it and fired it down the middle of the ice, and I hit my own defenseman between the eyes with the puck and gave him six stitches. So I never tried to score a goal ever again.
A story to tell years later. Here's Gouley across. One-time bomb, score! Not a power play goal, but that was a rocket delivered up top. And the Habs got one more off the stick of Arbor Jack Guy. It's a 4-2 game.
And this was a bomb off the stick, but it was, if you look at the way that Linus Allmark played this, it's a bit awkward. Comes across. Oh, that hits a body. That's why I changed direction on him. I knew, because just watching him, that hit Cole Reinhart. So that hits Reinhart kind of in the chest area. That's going blocker. It ends up going glove side on Allmark, because watching his body language, he had pushed from right to left, and all of a sudden it ended up going on the left side. But Montreal makes it 4-2 with just over 11 minutes left.
Good rocket from Arbor Jacki. That was one of the positives last year, Jamie, for Montreal. They had a lot of offense from the back end. Actually close to leading the league in durations of the regular season last year. Mike Matheson had career highs in points. A lot of the blue liners did. William Trudeau, he'll wrist it in for Montreal. Sanderson back, in comes Pezzetta. Gregor under duress, so he'll throw it behind his goalie. Evans reaching for it. Gregor plays it away for Artem Zub. Zub to center, collected by Montreal. Trudeau. He'll dish up ahead for Gallagher, and it's brought in offside with 10-11 to go here in this third period. So a little bit of life here. Arbor Jack Guy, he's made a statement in the preseason, and this time he makes it with that big slap shot from the far point. It's 4-2.
Today, when it comes to comparing players, the backs of their hockey cards just won't cut it. Get the stats behind the stats with NHL Edge, featuring its one-of-a-kind comparison tool. So you're not just comparing point totals. You're comparing speed, shot power, and impact on the game.
Eichel shoots, scores!
But if we're being honest, you can't compare style points. At least not yet. Know more about every stat, every shift, and every star with NHL Edge.
Virgin Plus is obviously the choice for affordable phone plans with lots of data. So is the selling power of a certified actor doctor really necessary? Does it help if 10 out of 10 pretend doctors agree it's easy on the wallet? Or that you get discounts on food, fashion, and entertainment? Your glasses aren't real. Do we need all this doctory stuff to convince you? We don't. Because when you're choosing an affordable phone plan, the obvious choice is Virgin Plus. Obviously.
My life is full of questions.
Mom, is yellow a light or a dark?
How do I clean an aioli stain?
Thankfully, Tide's the answer to almost all of them.
Why do we even buy napkins?
Hey, let me start.
In cold water, clean white socks.
It can with Tide.
Do I need to pre-treat guacamole?
Not with Tide.
This is chocolate, right?
Just use.
Tide? Mm. Yeah.
No matter who's doing it, on what cycle, or in what temperature, Tide works. So I can focus on all the other questions.
Do crabs have eyebrows?
For all of life's laundry questions, it's got to be Tide.
Take another peek at the Arbor Jacki goal. The puck gets turned over. Gonna go low to high, D to D, and then this hits Cole Reinhart in the high slot off the chest area. Changes directions on Linus Allmark. They talked before, he was pushing from right to left, and it ended up going past on the glove side. Jacki just gets it away quickly, gets a favorable bounce, and you got a 4-2 game.
Caden Gouley picking up a helper in his first preseason game. Shots now 6-0 Montreal in this period. 10 minutes remaining of preseason time here in Ottawa. Buzzing around Nick Cousins. Got taken down by Trudeau. Trudeau has the puck. He'll lead the rush with Anderson and Gallagher. Brandon Gallagher across. Allmark down and out, and he stopped it. Good chance by Barron, who jumped into the play, and Allmark stayed right with the young defender.
And a little two-pad stack from Linus Allmark. That's old school. Paddle down, two-pad stack, and anticipates the pass coming back through the seam.
There's Amadio. Pinto. That shot missed out of the net. And Yannick couldn't jam that home, and that'll deflect out of play.
Justin Barron's done a good job jumping up in the play, showing some speed, but it's Linus Allmark with the old-school Billy Ranford two-pad stack. As Gallagher slides it back door and then come back through the seam, waiting, looking for Josh Anderson on the back door, and Allmark uses that 6'4" frame to lay down. Take that away.
The Vezina winner in 2023. Jensen shot. Amadio in front, digging for it, and Montembeau able to answer with a save. You know, I've said Michael Amadio's name a lot in this preseason in the two games.
I think he's been exactly what the Ottawa Senators have needed, a veteran guy. The details of his game are really sharp. He's got some skill to his game, but he also has some bite and some physicality. It's a real nice acquisition.
Look out, turnover on cue. Amadio waiting for help. Amadio curls around, protects the puck behind the net. He'll dish to the corner. There's Norris. Norris swings it back in. Jan Yannick. Yannick. He'll hand it off. Norris in front, pass through the crease. Two blows up, and I think a piece of the glove, and Montembeau got enough, then off the glass. Batherson. Waits, wrist shot. That's deflected. Good bodies in front of Montembeau. Norris again. Zub hands it off. That wrist shot knocked down in front. Never got through to Montembeau. Good block there by Caden Gooley. Sanderson throws it far corner. Kapanen plays it around the boards. Wanted new hook. Good pressure here by Ottawa. Norris curls around. Under eight to go, third period. 4-2 game. Norris. Another block, Gooley. And Gooley dives and swats that down the ice. Good job by the young defenseman, who's looked pretty good here in his preseason debut after missing some time, game time anyways.
I think he's looked really good. Physical right from the drop of the puck, 5 seconds in. He jumped into the play, made a couple nice plays. To me, he's a guy that, you know, didn't wade his way into the water. He wanted to assert himself immediately.
Christian Dvorak cutting in around Hamidek. Heinemann. Try to jam at far point. A stop shot. A little bit of pace. Wade shoots. Hits the side of the net. A stop shot. And Engstrom tangled up. Dug out by Dvorak. Bit of a dangerous play, but no harm done there. Pretty confident Logan Mayhew decided to just drive play himself in front of his goalie. Mayhew was actually third in team goals in Laval last year, fifth in overall scoring. Had a nice offensive upside with the Rocket. That drive bounces and cleaned up by Ottawa. Fired in by Yannick. Trudeau takes the hit to move it up to Michael Pezzetta. Lost it in his skates. Pezzetta gets it back at center, and he'll flip it in. Pezzetta had a two-goal game earlier in the preseason. Not known for his offensive flair, but he's pretty excited about it and chatting with him earlier in the preseason back in Montreal.
Well, he's a gamer, Pezzetta. You know exactly what he's going to bring to the table every night. Plays a little reckless, which I don't mind, because you want that type on your team. Hate to play against it. But he plays for keeps. That's a guy that certainly comes to play every night and stands up for his teammates.
Allmark will squeeze. 5:43 to go. And that was dumped in at center, then squeezed by the goalie, so no faceoff.
Quickly give a shout-out to Tony Vanderveen, coaches for the South Stormont Selects. Had a serious surgery in Toronto. We're all thinking of him. and his family and his loved ones.
Send her best to Tony.
Fan of the Sens.
Off the draw, Gouley zips it across. Gallagher towards the net, and Allmark tried to scoop it. Evans was in front looking for a rebound, and Ottawa able to clear. McEwen up for Amadio. Slash to center. Jake Evans there with Josh Anderson. Comes back to Engstrom. He'll send it to the right side. There's Caden Gouley. He'll wrist it in. Brendan Gallagher. Engstrom. Time in the SHL last season, the top league in Sweden. Both teams getting a change in. 5 minutes remaining in this third period as we wrap up the preseason in the nation's capital.
Seems to have gone on for 3.5 years. This preseason has, I don't know how you feel, Brian, but this preseason has been very long. There's talked to a few coaches and players that, you know, some teams have played 8 games. It's a lot of games in a short span of time. But I think what it is people are just chomping at the bit to get in the regular season. So you've got veteran players that want to play, a few that just want to settle in. You've got young players that want to make an impression. And you want coaches that want to get into practice so that they can implement their system. So everybody's got a different motivation to get going. Broadcasters, you've done a bunch of games. We're excited to get back to the season when it's for keeps.
Well, and Sheldon Keefe's 2-0, man.
Yeah,
New Jersey Devils, they're 2-0, and we're still wrapping up the preseason here.
You know, listen, it's nice that the NHL can try and grow the game overseas. But, you know, Buffalo now 0-2 to start the season and only scored 2 goals. But certainly New Jersey's looked really good early on.
Yeah, a lot of chatter, Jamie, about, you know, do you extend the regular season, drop a couple preseason games, showcase your rookies maybe a little bit more, letting the fan base know. I know Montreal, the rookie showcase, Jamie, the Bell Center was sold out. I mean, the excitement level was unbelievable. And that's 21,000 in that building. It was awesome.
Well, it was nice. I talked to somebody on the Leaf coaching staff and said the fan base was just amazing. And both fan bases represented there at the Bell Center, obviously more Montreal fans.
Turnover inside, across, one-time drive, what a stop. Cousins robbed by Montembeau.
Great save, Mark, that one. It might be a little late, but Montembeau giving his team a chance to stay within 2 goals.
But you're a goalie, Jamie, in the preseason. I mean, that's got to feel good. You're getting ready for the real deal versus Toronto.
Absolutely, and it didn't look good early on for Montembeau. He'd given up 4 goals halfway through this game, but he settled in. His team actually settled in. It was more, not so much him, but his team started to play better in front of him.
Thomas Chabot in for McEwen, behind the net, centering feed. And it popped free, cleaned up by Christian Dvorak. 3 minute mark, third period. In comes Gallagher. Our first game, Habs on TSN, will be in Boston next week. The second half of a back-to-back. Montreal opens up versus Toronto at home, and then we'll have the game at Boston for you.
Ottawa opens up against the Stanley Cup champs. But you mentioned the Habs in Boston. You wonder if former Sens goaltender Jonas Korpisalo will be in net. Certainly looks that way right now with Jeremy Swayman not having a contract.
Artem Zub back in his own zone. Kapanen racing after him. Brébolé to center. Time with Tampa Bay last year. And Montembeau is going to the bench. So extra attacker for Montreal. Why not? Net empty. There's Newhook towards the front of the net. Trying to get it to Brébolé in front. Couldn't pull the trigger. Newhook knocks it down. Good stick. Engstrom. Brébolé zips out across. And too much heat for Heinemann. Couldn't get the shot off. Newhook. Brébolé is parked in front, as is Heinemann. Newhook. Oh, and Engstrom couldn't handle it. Bobbling puck, and that'll be wide of the net. Gets Ottawa a change. Minute 20 to go.
You have to wonder if Allmark would go for the empty net or if he got an opportunity. I'm thinking yes.
Yeah, preseason, why not? He's already got one, Joshua Waugh. Backhand try, never got through. The Cousins will just ship that, and Engstrom picks it up. Final minute, Saturday night, Canadian Tire Center, third period. Ottawa 4-2, Montreal net empty. Open net available, a stop check, and he'll miss with the backhand. Well, Stopchuk could have sealed it right there. The Cousins shooting. That hits the body, goes wide. Noah Gregor in the corner. 40 seconds left. Gallagher trying to free Josh Anderson. Ottawa's got to stay on side. They will. Montreal controls. 30 seconds left. Brendan Gallagher. Nice move. Gallagher to the forehand. And Clevin cleans it up. Caden Gooley in the corner. Gooley. Pass behind Dvorak. Puck played to center. Available, McEwen, and he misses the empty net. And that'll be icing, 7 seconds remaining in preseason, and a face-off in front of Linus Ullmark.
Been a pretty spirited effort here tonight, both organizations. Started with a goal early on, a fight. Ottawa took a commanding lead, Shane Pinto on the back of his hat trick, but it's for the Canadians that have a nice push here in the third period to make this a competitive game. Head coach Travis Green has to be happy with the effort of his group, some of the young players that looked good.
New hook, Mayu off the draw, a few seconds left, that bomb in the glove. Ullmark, he'll just steer it to the boards, and the preseason comes to an end. Ottawa Senators win their last three games of the exhibition season 4-2. Pinto the hat trick, and Ullmark gets the win.
Good showing for the Ottawa Senators on home ice. Give a taste for the fans to get pretty excited. And Linus Ullmark leading the way with a real solid effort. Stopping 23 for 25. Giving them the type of saves and goaltending that they've been looking for, consistency.
Linus Ullmark, great preseason, and 930 save percentage. And there you go, Canadian Tire sends hockey. It's the Panthers, the Cup champs, taking on Ottawa Thursday, 6:30 Eastern time, available in the Sens region. And Habs on TSN. We'll be in Boston, 7 Eastern time, Thursday. In the meantime, thanks for watching our preseason game, and good night from the nation's capital.
Come on in. Welcome to SportsCenter. Jermaine Franklin, Nikki Reyes here with you. And the NHL preseason is just about over. It
so
is
close.
Over for these two teams in the Sens and the Habs. And I got to admit, though, Nikki, preseason usually isn't that entertaining, but it really has been a little bit more this year. And
it really
why?
Has been.
The rough stuff.
Yeah.
These two teams certainly have a little bit of a rivalry going already in this preseason.
Yeah.
And it continued a little bit
yes.
tonight.
Yeah, the rivalry, you know, it's going to heat up, definitely, what we've seen these last two games, especially. Let's go back to Tuesday when these two teams last met. Let's flash back. Ridly Gregg lays a hit on Kirby Dock, and later in the game, Arbor Jack Eye responding with a high hit of his own on Tim Stützle. Overall, there were 77 minutes of penalties handed out. Just 4 days later, these two teams facing off again. Opening period, Jack Eye involved in a big collision at center ice and drops the glove with Zach McEwen. Not even 2 minutes into this one. Minutes later, Ottawa up 1-0 with a two-man advantage, and Jake Sanderson's point shot is tipped in by Shane Pinto. Pinto is second of the game, and Ottawa leads 2-0 early. Minutes after that, Caden Gooley, playing in his first preseason game, runs over Matthew Highmore. That draws a crowd as Jack Eye looks on from the box, but early in the second period, more from Pinto.
When they got rolling on their 16-game streak, it was their penalty power play.
Look out! Pinto in! Back in!
Pinto strips Alex Newhook of the puck and undresses Samuel Montembeau for the hat trick. Pinto scoring at even strength on the power play. And now, shorthanded, Ottawa up 4-1. Third period. Senators still 4-1. Montreal power play. Jack Eye wires it, and it hits off of a defender, and that one goes in. Jack Eye with a fight earlier in the game, now getting his first of the preseason. This one, final 4-2-2. So Brady Tkachuk, Claude Giroux, David Perron, and Tim Stützle among those who didn't play for Ottawa. With the preseason now wrapped up for both teams, the focus shifts to the regular season. The Habs' new campaign gets underway Wednesday night in Toronto, while Ottawa plays Florida on Thursday. With more now, here's Laura Dykin.
And join alongside our analyst, Carlo Koliakovo. So, good news. Preseason's now done. I know.
Yes,
I knew you were excited about that. Other good news, the Habs and the Sens, they were on pretty much their best behavior in this game, especially after what we saw on Tuesday.
Minus the first 10 minutes, but after that, things just calmed down.
They had to get it out a little bit there. And yes, some of the big names were missing on both sides here on this Saturday night. But one name that was playing and very deserving of that first star, Shane Pinto, who just wants to turn the page on last season with that suspension, signed that 2